Hello friends, I'm Nayashek from blogtut.com and thank you for watching this video. In this video, I'll teach you step by step how to create a perfect website for your business. We'll build this website using the best and latest technologies available. And creating this website is really easy. Anyone can create a website like this. Now let me show you what I mean by that. For example, if you want to change this text, for instead of small businesses, if you want to type in large businesses, you just select that and type in large businesses over here. Suppose you don't want this button over here, you can just delete it from here. And suppose if you have done any mistake, you can just press Ctrl and Z on your keyboard and you'll see that button again. And you can drag this button anywhere you want. For example, if you want the button at the top, we can do so. Okay, so this is really easy. If you don't want this image over here, you can just drag it over here. Okay, so you'll see this image coming over here and you can use the first one and drag it over here. So it is all drag and drop. You don't have to do any coding whatsoever. Okay, everything is really easy. If you want to make changes to any color or anything, for example, if you want to change the background color for this section, really easy. You can just go to this section, select background from here, and you can change the background color to anything you want. As you can see, now you can change. It is really easy. You just do some clicks and everything will be done. Now this is also looking really nice. So I just wanted to show you that it is really easy to create a website like this. Okay, if you like this thing, you just press this button and the changes are done. So it is that easy. And again, if you don't like this, you can just press Ctrl Z and all the changes will be undone. As you can see, all the changes are getting undone. Okay. Now let's see the website which we'll be creating in this video. So this is the website which we'll be creating in this video. Now this is our first section. At the top we have this navigation bar, we have our header. At the left hand side we have a beautiful logo. I'll show you how to create this. Then at the right hand side we have this nav bar, we have different menus. We can also include a button in the menu. We'll see how to do that. And a very interesting thing about this video is that it is both a single page website and a multi-page website. Nowadays, single page websites are also very famous. You know, the difference between single page website and multi-page website is very simple. In single page website, you just have one page as your entire website. You don't have any external pages. For example, in one single page, you have different sections for different things. For example, in one page, you have about us section, contact us section, and services section, and so on. So you have everything in just one single page. Your entire website is just that one single page. So that is what a single page is. And a multi-page website is the normal website which we see. We have different pages like about us page, contact us page, and so on. So let me show you how a single page website looks like. For example, if you see over here, this is our navigation bar. When I hover home, I get different options like services, about us, contact us. Now suppose you want to go to contact us section, so you just click on contact us. Now if you see over here, this is the contact us section. Now this has not redirected us to some other page. This is the same page, but it is a different section. Now suppose you want to go to the testimonial section, you'll click on testimonials and you'll be redirected to this section. So that is what a single page is. And a multi-page is really simple. When you want to go to about us page, you click on about us and you will be redirected to the about us page. So first let me refresh this page because I want to show you all the animations in this. So as you can see, this is the animation for the top section. This is our top section and this is a very beautiful section. We have a title, then we have a bigger title, then we have a divider, then subtitle and a call to action button. Now this is a very famous design and a very useful design, very productive design I would say, because this design is inspired by many big companies like Apple, Microsoft and so on. Those companies have a similar kind of design for their website. And now I have given it some special touch by using this beautiful divider. If you see over here at the bottom, this is the divider and this really beautifies the website. This really makes it amazing and unique. And I am damn sure that you might have not seen these kind of dividers and beautiful things in most of the websites. Now this is very unique, this is very new and very latest. So as I said you earlier, we'll be using the latest technology. We'll see how to use this divider as well. And throughout the website, I have used this divider. And also if you notice one thing, the background color is not any regular solid color, like it is not just blue. It is a combination of two different colors. So I'll show you how to do that as well. Now let's move on to the next section. Now as I scroll down, you can see the animations going on. So I'll show you how to do all these animations. It is really, really easy. So this is the second section. Now this is the design that we'll be following. We have a title over here and we have some subtitle for that one with a very beautiful design. Then again, we have a divider, subtitle and three different services. You can link one or all these services to different pages or different posts if you want. Now let's scroll down and again you can see all these beautiful animations. This is the third section that we'll be creating in this particular page. And by the way, we'll be creating six different pages like home page, about us page, services page, blog page, booking page and get in touch page, or you can say contact us page. So we'll see that thing later on. First, let's see the home page. Let's see how the home page looks like. And for the homepage, I have taken inspiration from a free layout which I found on Google, local biz layout. So I have given the link to that in the video description below. You can check that out. So here we have two different sections, two different columns. In the first column, we have some text about our company. And the second column, we have a beautiful form, get in touch form. Then after that, we have this about section, about us section. Why should you choose us? Why should a customer or a client choose your company? And again, we have over here, if you see, we have used parallax images. You can see, if you can notice both the images, this is parallax effect. So that is what it is. And at the last, we have this section, this testimonial section. Then at the last, we have the footer section. Now you'll find this section in all the pages that I have created on this website. And I'll show you how to do that very, very easily. Once you create one single column or one single section, you can save that and you can reuse them any number of times you want. Okay. So this was our homepage. If you guys want to see how this page looks like, you can go and check the demo website link in the video description below. It is dv.nayashik.com. If you go to that website, you can see the exact same website that I have created over here. Now this was the homepage. Let's see how the about us page looks like. So this is our about us page. At the top, we have the top section and you'll find this section in all the different pages that I have created. Okay. We have this divider. We have the background color. Then we have the title over here, about us. And at the back, we have our story. Then we have two different sections or two different columns. The first one is a company photo, any image, any stacked image. We have a title, something about a company and a call to action button. After that, we have this progress bar, some text and another image. Then after that, we have this section. Now here also, I have used beautiful dividers and beautiful colors. This section is also divided into two different columns. The first column is availability. You can have your timing like daily care, your address and so on, and some reviews by your customers. Then after that, we have our members. So this is how your members section will look like. Member 1, member 2, member 3. You have their name, designation, something about them and their social profile. Then after that, as I said you earlier, we have the same section in the footer. Okay. Now let's see the next page, which is the services page. So this is how our services page would look like. This is the top section. This is also similar throughout the website. After that, we have this section, why choose us? And we have four different services over here or four different features you can see. We give 5-star service. We are available 24/7, schedule ahead, no wait list. Then after that, we have the services section, 1, 2, 3 services. Now, if you notice, these three services are already created on the homepage. So we'll not create them again. I'll show you a very easy and a very beautiful method of using the same thing which you have created throughout your website. So that is going to be really amazing. Then again, as I said you earlier, we have this footer section throughout the website. So this was the third page, the services page. Now let's see how the blog page looks like. So this is our blog page. It says our blog is the title and in the background we have articles. Now I have tried to give a very different look to this blog page. As you can see, it is really looking beautiful. It has got some border radius, some shadows and nice, you know, very beautiful images and so on. I have given it a very clean and elegant look to this page. because I went and I did a lot of research in, you know, trying to find out how should our website be looking in 2018, 2019, what are the latest designs that are coming in the market and so on. So these things, whatever I have created in this video, everything is dependent on the latest technology. Okay. Now let's see a very special page, booking page, which I have not shown earlier. This page I have not created before in any one of my videos. Now this is really amazing. So this is the booking page. We have a very similar section, the title first. Then we have these three different blurbs. First one is step one, fill out the form. Step two, get confirmation email. Step three, enjoy your life. Okay. So we have used different colors and very beautiful and light colors. And we have also used different icons, like you can see this note icon, envelope icon and heart icon. After that, we have this very beautiful form. You can see the design is really, really amazing. Here also we have used some really amazing thing. If you see, there is a nice amount of shadow and border radius so that it looks nice and clean. And at the bottom, we have this fact section, frequently asked question section. You can add more questions and answers over here. Now let's see the last page that we'll be going to create, get in touch page or contact us page. So this is that get in touch page. We have this contact form over here at this section. And after that, we have details about our company. So suppose someone doesn't want to call you, but they can fill this form and we can, you know, call them back. Now at the bottom, we have three different sections. As you can see here, you can put in your address, your phone number and your email address. Okay, so these were all the different pages that we are going to create in this website. Okay guys, so this was the website that we'll be creating in this video. I hope you guys like the design and you guys are excited to make this website. If yes, then stay tuned. To create any kind of website, we need two basic things. First, a domain name, and second, a hosting account. Now, a domain name is nothing but the URL or the name of your website. For example, google.com is a domain name, youtube.com is a domain name, yahoo.com is a domain name. So it is just the name which you type on your URL bar to reach the website. So suppose you want to go to youtube.com, what do? You just type in youtube.com and you reach that website. So that is what a domain name is. And hosting account is also very similar. For example, if you see this website over here, we have some images over here, some files and everything. For example, these are three different images. So all these files, all these images, all the HTML, CSS files are saved somewhere in a computer which is running 24/7. So that anyone who comes to your website, they can see all the files and everything over here. So that is what a hosting account is. It is just a simple thing. It is a computer or a hard drive wherein all your data, all your website data is saved. So we need these two things. Without this, we just cannot proceed further. Now there are many different companies that provide domain and hosting services, but I want to show you guys the best company that we can select, that I personally use and I recommend my friends and family members to use whenever they want to make any website, because the website or the company that we are going to use is the best in the market. It has the fastest hosting services and a really affordable price. So if you want to use that, just open a new tab and type in blog2.com/tmd. Okay, this link is also given in the video description below. You can click on that link and you will be redirected to this particular page. Okay guys, so as you can see, there is some discount going on, but this discount is on the shared hosting plan, and we don't want the shared hosting plan because that is the regular plan. We want the fastest plan possible, fastest hosting plan, and the best and the most amazing hosting plan possible. For that, we'll be using cloud hosting. So here you'll see a button which says get into cloud now. Click on that button. Now here there are three different options: Starter Cloud, Business Cloud and Enterprise Cloud. Now as you can see, the plan starts with $6 per month, and the highest plan over here, the best plan over here, is $11 per month. Now let's see the different features that we are going to get with this company and why we should use this company instead of some other company in the market. So as I said you earlier guys, a hosting is nothing but a computer which has stored all your files and it is running 24/7. So the computer which these guys are using to host our file is a really nice and really robust computer. The computer which these guys are using has a 6-core CPU and 6GB of DDR4 RAM. So that is really amazing computer. Normal website companies use a very, very, you know, normal and very cheap kind of system to store all the data. In fact, even if you see over here starter cloud, the starter cloud has two CPU cores and 2 GB of DDR4 RAM. So there is a lot of difference and a lot of thing changes over here. After that, we have another feature which is unlimited bandwidth. Now, unlimited bandwidth means that you can upload and download unlimited amount of data from your website. So that is what it means. It is very important to have unlimited bandwidth. After that, we have the most amazing feature, the SSD space. Now, if you guys are familiar with computers, you know that SSD is way more faster than the HDD. Okay, the normal HDD is really slow and the SSD is really fast. And that's why SSDs are quite expensive than the HDD. Now, if you guys don't know the difference, you can just go to Google and type in SSD versus HDD web hosting. You'll get a fair idea. Now, if you see over here, there are many different posts and articles written on that. You can read any one of them. Or you can just click on images, okay, so you can see the difference over here. Now let's open the first image. If you see over here, there are three different criteria. The first one is speed. So the speed thing is over here. Now if you see over here, it says that SSD is way more faster than the normal and regular HDD. So the first one says higher is better. And you can see the SSD one, the green one, is way higher than the HDD. The second one is IOPS. Again, it says higher is better. Now you can see there's insane amount of difference between both of them. SSD is just way more higher. I think 100 times more higher than the normal HDD over here. And the third one is latency. Now this time it says lower is better. And again, you can see the difference over here. The difference is around 100 times. Okay. So this is 4 ms or 4 milliseconds and this is 0.04 milliseconds. So you can see the difference from this that SSD is really, really amazing. It is way more better and awesome than the normal HDD. Now, not only that, it has unlimited SSD space. So this is really good. After that, we have unlimited websites hosted. Now, this is also a very, very important feature. Why is that? Because suppose we are creating this website today, a business website. So we are hosting this website in this particular hosting plan. Now tomorrow, suppose you want to make another website, maybe an e-commerce website for your business. So you don't need to purchase a new hosting plan for that. You can just host the same website in this same plan. In fact, you can host unlimited websites in this same plan. So next time, if you want to create a website, you don't need to create or you don't need to, you know, open and pay for a new hosting account. You can use this account to host unlimited number of websites. So this is also a very important feature. After that, we have free domain. So we will be getting a free domain when we sign up with this package. So I got a free domain named nayashek.com when I signed up with TMD Hostings. We also get premium support, free cPanel, nice web server, and wildcard SSL. Now SSL is nothing but this secure socket over here. If you see the demo website or if you see any good website, any decent and reliable website, you'll find this secure socket over here. Now this is very, very important. It says the user who are using the website that this website is secure. And according to the recent news that is coming, now from June or July onwards, Google Chrome will be notifying the users that the website which they are using is secure or not. So if your website doesn't have this secure socket or SSL certificate, Google will say, or the Chrome browser will say to the visitor who is visiting your website that this website is not secure. Don't visit this website if you don't have that SSL certificate. So now today the SSL certificate has become very, very important and very, very crucial. Not only that, it has wildcard SSL. Now wildcard SSL means that you can have SSL certificates on unlimited number of websites and unlimited number of domains and subdomains. Now this is an insane offer. I really don't know what to say, because if you go to in the market to purchase a single SSL certificate, it will cost you around, you know, $40 to $100. So you're saving, you know, thousands of dollars if you're creating many different websites. So you'll have, you know, $40 of SSL certificate free on each single website. So this is really insane. After that, we have optimum cache memory instance of 256 MB. Now performance of this plan is 3 times better than these two plans. Then at the end, we also have a 60 days money back guarantee. So if you don't, if you're not satisfied, you can, you know, get money back guarantee for within 16 days. So you can compare all these things. If you want, you can go with the business plan or the business cloud or the enterprise cloud. Don't go with the starter cloud. I think that is not a good idea. The main reason is that you can host only one website in the starter cloud, and also the hosting company, the hosting computer which these guys are using is not that good. So I would not recommend you guys to go with starter cloud. You can go with business cloud or the enterprise cloud. Now I'll be going with the enterprise cloud because that is what I'm using right now. Okay. So what I'll do is I'll click on this button which says get started. Now once you do so, you'll be redirected to this page. Here you have to type in the domain name which you want for free. So I'm typing in nayashake.com, or you can just type in nayashake one, or you can type in any domain name you want. Okay. And after typing in the domain name, you can select any extension. For example, if you want .com, .net or .org, whatever you want, you can select that. If you're creating this website for some organization, you can select .org. If you're creating this website for any very country specific, for example, if you're creating this website for only Indian users, Indian visitors, you can select .in, or for UK, you can select .uk. But for most of you guys who are watching this video, I would recommend you to go with .com. That is the most trusted and most common thing, most common extension that any domain name uses. Once you type in your domain name and select a best extension for your domain name, you can just click on this proceed button. Once you do so, you'll be redirected to this page. Now here you have to type in some basic contact information like your first name, last name, email address, phone number and so on. After that, you have to fill in your payment information. If you want to make payment through credit card, debit card or your ATM card, you can select this. You can select your card type like Visa, MasterCard, whatever card type of card you're using, type card number and all these things, and you can make payment through that. If you want to make payment through PayPal, you can select PayPal from here and you can make payment through this. Then after that, we have this section, purchase information section. The first option over here is data center location. Now you'll see a drop down over here and you have to select the one which says nearest to you. So for me, Singapore says nearest to you, so I'll select Singapore. Then after that we have period. So by default 12 months is selected, and I would recommend you guys also to select 12 months. Okay, because if you select 1 month, you'll have to pay $7 extra per month, which is not a good idea. So I would recommend you guys to select 12 months. That is the most amazing thing. Okay. Now after that, we have some more options. By default, domain privacy is tick mark. Now if you tick mark this thing, you'll have to pay $10 extra per year, but you'll get a benefit that no one can see who has registered this website. For example, no one can see your first name, last name, email address and so on. So that is a good idea to secure your domain privacy. It's all up to you. If you don't want that, if you want to save $10 per year, you can just untick this. Now after that, we have the most important option, the promo code. This is the most important option because this is the option that is going to save you some money. So here you have to type in Nayar7, N-A-Y-Y-A-R, numeric 7, and click on apply. Now this domain or this coupon code is also given in the video description below. You can check that out. Okay. Now as you can see here, it says this promo code gives you 7% off this purchase. So you're getting 7% discount on this promo code. Now this is very important because 7% is the highest discount that TMD offers on cloud hostings. So I think that is really amazing. You are getting the highest discount possible. So after you're satisfied with everything, just tick mark over here which says I agree to the TMD terms of services and click on checkout. Now once you click on that checkout button, you'll receive an email from TMD. Now this email is really, really important. Okay, because it has some really crucial information like your username, your FTP password, your name servers, you know, all these important informations are over here, your cPanel link and everything. So make sure you guys save this email and you secure all these things somewhere. Okay, if you have multiple email addresses, you can forward this mail to those different email addresses. Just make sure you have all this information secured. Okay. You can copy and paste everything and, you know, keep them in your computer. You can take a printout of this. Do whatever you think is safe for you. Now, what we have to do is at the bottom, you'll see a link which says control panel link. Now, open that link in a new tab. Okay, so that link is nothing but your domain name slash cPanel. Okay, so your control panel link would be your domain name slash cPanel. For example, if my domain name is nayashik.com. So my cPanel link will be nayashik.com/cPanel, or you can also visit cPanel.yourdomainname.com. Okay, so there are different ways of visiting this your cPanel. Now you have to copy this username and password from that email address, paste in over here and click on login. Oh yeah, so this is your cPanel, your control panel. Now there are many different options available over here, but we have to go at the bottom under Softaculous app installer and click on WordPress, because now it's time to install WordPress on our website. So you'll see this option over here. You have this install now button, click on that. Now from here you have to choose in the domain name. If you're creating this website for the first time, you will have only one domain name over here, because I have used TMD for creating hundreds of websites. That's why I have many different domain names. So I'll have to select the one which I want to use. So I want to install WordPress on this domain. Now you have to choose a protocol which says HTTPS, okay, the one which says HTTPS, so that you can have this secure socket, this SSL certificate over here. Now if you see this box, the in directory box, WP is already typed over here. Now make sure you delete that. Make sure this box is empty, nothing is typed over here. After that, scroll down. The next option are site settings. You have to give a name and a description to your website. Now you can change these things from here, or you can do them later on from your dashboard, from your WordPress dashboard. Okay, so you can make some changes over here, or you can change them in the WordPress dashboard. After that, we have the most important setting, the admin account settings. You have to choose a username and password. Don't do the mistake of, you know, leaving this to admin and pass. If you do so, your site will get hacked within few days. So don't do that mistake. Just change this, have any username you want, and change this password as well. Okay, so I'm changing this password and putting in my own password. After that, put in an email address of your choice. Okay, so this is very important. Anytime something happens to your website, new user registered to your website, or you get some message from someone when someone, you know, fills in that contact form, anything happens to your website, you'll get a notification on this email. So make sure you put in your email address over here. Then go at the bottom and click on this install button. Now WordPress is getting installed on your website and it will take few seconds. So just don't worry. As I said, it took few seconds. Now we get two different links over here. The first one is your website link, and the second one is your dashboard or your administrative link. Okay, so click on this second link, your administrative URL, and we can get rid of all these things. Okay guys, so this is your WordPress dashboard. This is the place from where you'll control everything that happens on your website. You can create new pages, new posts, everything from here. Okay, so this is how your dashboard looks like. Now let me zoom in a bit so that you can see everything more properly. Okay, now there are many different options. We'll see one by one everything. Now first, after installing WordPress, we have to do some changes. Okay, so how you do that? At the left hand side, you have some options like post, media. If you want to create a new post, you go to hover post and click on add new. If you want to add or upload some new media like images, audio or video file, you can upload some media from here. Okay, we'll see all these options later on. First, we'll have to do some general settings, some important settings. So let's do that. First, hover settings and go at the bottom and select the last option, permalinks. Okay, so by default, the day and name link is selected. Now we don't have to select that one. Now what I want you guys to do is select custom structure, because now I'm going to give you the best custom structure, the best permalink structure, which is SEO friendly, because it is very important to have a SEO friendly permalink so that, you know, your website gets ranked higher on Google. That is very, very important. Now once you select custom structure, make sure you delete everything from here. Select everything and delete it. Now from the bottom, you'll see different options. First, click on category. And after that, click on post. Oh, let me find that. Here it is, post name. So first click on category, you'll have this category over here, then after that post name. Now what does that mean? Now if you do this option, what happens is first whatever your page name is, first the category name will come in the URL bar and after that the post name. So this is very very important. If you don't understand this, don't worry, we'll see these things later on, okay? Just follow me for now and do whatever I do, okay? If you don't understand these things, don't worry, you'll understand these things later on. Now after you do this custom structure setting, click on save changes. Fine, so the changes are saved. Now you can click on this general settings under the settings, click on general. Now here you can change your site title and your description or your tagline. Okay, so let me give a site title of DV 3.0 because we'll be using the DV theme, the latest version 3.0. And let us give it a tagline of YouTube demo. Now you can also change your email address from here. Now go at the bottom and click on save changes. Now at the left hand side, you'll see an option called appearances, hover appearances, and click on themes. Now if you see over here, there are three different themes automatically installed on your website. Now what I want you guys to do is delete all these themes because we don't need this. And whatever you don't need, you don't require, just delete them because we want our website to be very fast. We don't want any unnecessary things to be there on our website. Now that unnecessary thing will make your website a bit slower. So that is not recommended. And for those of you guys who are new to WordPress, theme is nothing but the design of your website. So whenever you want to change the design of your website, you purchase a new theme or you install some free themes and you can change the design of your website. So that is very easy. Now the theme which we'll be using in this video to create this website, to create this amazing website, is called DV theme. Now DV is the number one WordPress theme and there is no doubt in that. Now DV is really famous, really useful and the most amazing theme, and the most amazing feature about DV is that it has a pre-built page builder. In fact, that is the best page builder available on internet. The only page builder that comes close to the DV page builder is Elementor, which has come recently and it is really famous. But I still think that DV is still better than Elementor. So we'll be using DV and I'll give you a very special link that will save you some money on DV. So what you can do, you can open a new tab and type in blog2.com/DV10. Okay. This link is also given in the video description below. You can check, click on that link and you'll be redirected to this page. So as you can see, when you follow my link, you'll get 10% discount on both the packages. There are two packages available, yearly access and lifetime access. So if you want to use DV throughout your lifetime, if you want to get updates throughout the lifetime, you can purchase the lifetime access. Now this is really good for, you know, developers, freelancers, web designers. But for most of you guys who are regular people who just want to create a website for their business, I would recommend you to use the early access. And by using this early access, you'll have access to all the themes, that elegant theme. This is a website, a company. So this company has different themes. So you'll get all the themes and it has some plugins. You'll get all the plugins for free and you'll get updates on all the themes and plugins for 1 year. So for 1 year, you don't have to do anything. Now, many people think that whenever you select a yearly access plan, what happens is after 1 year, your website shut down. Okay, that is not what happens. You just don't get the updates after 1 year. Now, that is not really required. Okay, you can create a website like this really easily with this plan. You just now in future, if DV launches some new updates to their page builder, you'll get keep on getting those updates for 1 year. But after 1 year, you'll not get the update, but you'll still have the theme and you'll still have all the website running very perfectly. And you can use this thing on unlimited number of websites. Now, this is really amazing. Because most of the themes which you purchase, you can use them only on one website. But this theme, you can use on unlimited number of websites. So I think this is really, really, amazing and really useful. Because for one single theme, you can use on unlimited number of websites. You can use that single page builder on any number of websites if you want. Okay, so this is really amazing. So if you want to purchase this theme, you can select any one of the plan. I would recommend for most of the people, for normal people, to go with the early access, yearly access plan. And for freelancers, web designer, developers, I would recommend lifetime access. Okay, so if you want to go with the yearly access, just click on sign up today button. Now fill in this form, very small, very easy to fill, just few things over here, and you can make payment through Visa, MasterCard, American Express card, or you can just make payment through PayPal. Now I won't be doing this because I have already purchased this, so I'll just cut this thing. Now once you purchase that theme, you'll get a file. Okay, now we have to upload that file. So what you can do is you can click on this add button. Now click on upload theme button, choose file, and you can, let me select that file. Okay, here it is. Select this file, click on open. Now click on install now. So if you see at the bottom left corner of your browser, you can see the progress. It is around 27-29%. And it will take few seconds to install the theme, so we can wait till then. Now till then, what you can do is you can click on that small red button, that subscribe button, so that you don't miss any future videos. And also click on that bell icon. That will be really amazing, because in future if I create any new amazing videos, you can get a notification for that. Okay, so we get an error. It says the uploaded file exceeds the upload, whatever the error is. Now this is really easy to solve. I could have solved this earlier and then showed you, but I just wanted to show you that there will be an error if you don't follow these steps which I am showing you. Okay, so first let's come back. So why is this error happening? So what happens is, by default WordPress allows user to upload files only up to 2 MB. Okay, if your file size is more than 2 MB, you will not be able to upload that file on WordPress. Now it is very easy to change this. First let's see the problem. When you see at the left hand side, you'll see media. You can hover media and click on add new. Now here if you see at the bottom, it says maximum upload file size is 2 MB. Now this is what we have to increase. So what you can do is you can go to my website blogdude.com. In fact, I'll give a link to the to this page or to this post in the video description below. You can check out that link. Now let me go to this post. Here it is, maximum upload size exceeded. So this is the step wherein I have shown how to solve this thing. So it is really easy. What you can do, what you have to do is just open FileZilla. Okay, let's open FileZilla. If you don't know how to set up FileZilla, you can watch, there is a video on my channel which where I have shown how to set up FileZilla. You can watch that video, that will be very helpful. But if you have already set up FileZilla, you can follow me. Now once you open FileZilla, you'll see there are different folders over here. Now you have to select the folder with your website name. For example, my website name here is dv.nayashek.com. So I'll have to find a folder with that name. So here, as you can see, here it is dv.nayashek.com. Just open that folder. Now here you'll find one file, the first file, which is .htaccess. Now what you have to do from this side, if you see over here, you have to select your desktop. So here it is. Just select your desktop from here and drag this file on your desktop. Okay. So once you drag this file on your website, it says transfer finished. Let's see whether the file is here. Okay, here it is. This is the file. So let us open this file. Now we have to do some changes in this file. Now it is also very easy. What you can do is you can copy these codes from here, these few lines of code from here. Just copy it from here. Now go to that file. Here it is. And paste in these codes over here. Okay, it is that simple. Just copy these codes from here and paste it over here. Now press Ctrl and S. After that, cancel this thing. Now again go to FileZilla. Now this is your computer section. So what you can do, you can right click over here and click on refresh to refresh this section. Okay, right click, refresh. Now you can drag this file again to your website folder. Okay, now it will ask you to overwrite the file. So you just select overwrite and click on OK. So it says transfer finished. Let's get rid of this. Let's cancel these things. Let's cut this link. Now earlier it said 2 MB maximum upload file size. Now let's refresh and see. Okay, now as you can see, it says maximum upload file size has increased to 64 MB. Now we can upload any file size up to 64 MB. So again, hover appearances and click on themes. Let's try it again. Click on add new, upload themes, choose file. Again, select that file, click on open, install now. Okay, so it is getting installed around 10, 12, 15% progress. And again, I will request you guys, if you have any doubt, any queries, if you want to ask anything, if you have any suggestion for me, you can leave them in the comment section below. I always try to reply to the comments with, you know, so I would really appreciate if you guys have any suggestions for me. If you have any doubt, any questions for me, you can leave them in the comment section below. Okay, so I think it is uploaded. It is loading. Oh yeah, so as you can see, the theme is successfully uploaded. Now we'll have to activate the theme. So let's activate it. Okay, so it's, as you can see, now we have the active theme. The DV theme is the active theme. Now we can delete this theme as well, the 2017 theme. So let's delete this. Now if you want to see how your website is looking at present, you can hover over here and open this link, the visit site link, in a new tab. Okay, so this is how your website is looking at present. Now from here, the most amazing and the fun part begins. Now we'll see how to convert this simple and blank page into something amazing like this. Now it is really amazing and really interesting doing these things. So first we'll have to create this home page. So let's do that. Come back to your dashboard. From the left hand side, you'll see these pages, hover pages, and click on add new. Now you can give it any title you want. So I'm giving this page a title of home page. Okay. So once you give a title, just click on this button which says use the DV builder. After that, select the use the visual builder. So we'll be using the visual builder so that we can see all the changes that is taking place on our website in front of our eyes. Okay. So we don't have to make some changes, then go to the page, then again, come back, make some changes. Okay. We can see the changes that are taking place on our website live. Now just click on this button which says start building. Okay guys, so this is the blank canvas and now it's time to create everything step by step. So let's see first what we have. So we have this section at the top. Now let's first understand a very simple thing. Now when you see Ivana hover this thing, you will see this blue section over here. Now this is called a section. Okay, so the website is divided into different sections. For example, this section is the first section till this divider. This is one section, and then from here till this section is another section. Then this thing is another section. Okay, so this is a section, and in that section we have different columns. Okay, so this green section is columns. So as you can see, everything over here comes under this section, the column section. If you want, you can make different columns, multiple columns. For example, at present we have only one column. If you want to increase the column size, you can select this, you can make it four columns. Now we have four columns over here, okay? But here we have only one column at the top. So let's again select one column from here. If you want to do that, you can just select the fourth icon over here, select that and select the first one, the first column. Okay, so we want only one column, and in that column the first thing that we have is a text. Okay, free DV layout pack. You can type in any text you want, but I'll be typing the same text that we have in the demo website, because my aim is to teach you guys to create the exact same website. So I'll be copying the same text that we have over here. So let me show you how to do that. Now once you want to add anything in this column, you add it through module. Okay, so if you want to add a new module, just click on this black plus button. Just click on that, you'll get a pop-up. Now there are many different modules over here, you can select any one of these. Now because we want to add a text, we'll select a module called text. Okay, so you'll just type text and you'll see this module. Okay, select this thing. Now you can drag this thing anywhere you want. Okay, so this is also very useful. You can drag it anywhere you want. Now let's type in the text that we want. So what I'll do, I'll just paste it over here. I'll have copied it from here and paste it over here. Now as you can see, when I pasted this thing, I can see this thing over here. Okay, the text is showing over here, free DV layout pack. So once you put in the text, now the next step is to design it. As you can see over here, the design is different. The color of the text is different. There is a nice amount of gap between letters. So we'll have to add some letter spacing. Also the size of the text, the size of the font is quite bigger. So let's design it. Okay. So there are two or three different sections. The first one is the content section. This is the main section. You add your content over here. After that, we have the second section, which is the design section. You just click on this section and you'll see all the design options. Now in this section, we will see how to design this module. Okay. So these three sections are there for all the modules, whether you're using a blurb module, a text module, a form module, you'll see the content and the design section. So first we have added the content. Now let's design it. Okay. So we have different options. First one is text. Let's select text. Okay. So as you can see here, the text color is dark. If you select light, it will become white. So as you can see, it has disappeared because the background color is also white. So for now, let's make it dark. Now text font, you can change and select any font you want. You have hundreds of fonts, hundreds of thousands of fonts over here. You can select any one you want. For example, you can search for any font. For example, when I type Robo, I get Roboto, Roboto Condensed, Roboto Mono. You know, these are different fonts. And if you want to see how that form looks like, you can see, you know, you can just hover that font and you'll see how it will look like. Now let me select Roboto. Now as you can see, the font has changed. Now I don't want Roboto, I just want the default font. So what I can do is I can just click on this icon, and now as you can see, it has turned to default. Now we can change the font weight. If you want to make it, you know, a bolder, you can select bold. Now as you can see, it has become bolder. You also have an ultra bold option. Okay, so again, I just want the regular one. You also have a light option, by the way. You can make it more lighter, as you can see over here. So I just want to make it regular. After that, you can change the text size. You can just drag this thing like this, and the text size of the font will change. Okay, so let's see over here. Here it is around, I guess, 30 pixels. So let's make it 30 pixels for here. If you want to change some more style, like if you want to make it underline, you can select underline from here. If you want to make it italic, you can select I from here, and so on. You can strike through this thing as well. After that, we have text color. So we'll change the text color later on. First, let's see all the different changes. Then we have letter spacing. As I said you earlier here, there are nice amount of space between all the letters. So that is what a letter spacing is. Now let's see what happens when we increase this letter spacing. As you can see, the space between the letters are increasing. Okay. So I think for this, let's make it to 5 or 6. I am putting 6. After that, you can add some shadow as well to the text. If you select any, you can see the changes that are taking place to the text. The text is getting some shadow, but we don't want to use this shadow thing now. We will be using the shadow options, but later on different modules. So don't worry. Now we can change the orientation. We can change the alignment. So we want to make it center aligned. So we can just click on this button and it will get center aligned. Okay. So this is how our font is looking at present. We'll have to change the color of the font and we'll have to make it white. But first, let's add some background color, because once we change the color to white, everything will disappear. Let me show you. Let's make the color of the font white. So let's go to text color, and instead of dark, let's make it white. Now click on OK. Now as you can see, the text has disappeared because the background color is also white. So let's change the background color. Okay, so to change the background color, you can just hover over here. You'll get this blue section, and here you have the second icon is a gear icon. Click on this gear icon or this setting icon. Now you'll see this pop-up. Now you can make some changes to this entire row. So what we have to do? We have to add some background image, okay, or background color. So let's select background from here. Let's add some color. Let's add red color. Okay, so this is how it will look. Okay, we have different colors. You can select any color you want. But here, if you see, we are using a combination of two colors. So if you want to use that, you can select this option, the second option. First, let's delete this. Okay, now we can select this option. Now click on add. Now as you can see, when we clicked on add, we get two different colors over here. Okay, now this is how the background is looking. Here also, we have a combination of two different colors, blue and something green. Okay. So here also we have the same color, but there is one small change over here. If you see the here at present, the blue color is at the top and the green color is at the bottom. But here in the demo website, we have the blue color at the left hand side, and at the right hand side, we have the green color. So you can change this thing as well. If you go at the bottom, you'll see this gradient direction. You can change this thing. Now, if you see, whenever I change this, you can see the changes on the website. So I have put it around 145 to 150 so that the blue comes over here and the green comes over here. Fine. So this is how you do it. Now after that we have this section, the divider, but we'll see the divider later on. First let's add the this text divider and all these things. After that we'll see this bottom divider. Okay, so for now just click on this OK button. First let's add the other text for small businesses. Let me copy this text. Now again come back over here, however here you'll again see this black button, black plus button. Click on that. Again search for text, because this is also a simple text. Select text and type in the text that you want. So here is it is for small businesses. Again let's go to design and let's design it. Okay, so first the text color is light, so select light from here. Now you can see it has become white. Now you can change the font and everything. Now wait, this is ultra bold. As you can see over here, this is nice bold font. Okay, so we'll select ultra bold. Now let's increase the size of this one, maybe to 70 pixels. Okay, 70 pixels will be fine. After that we have text color, which is already white. You can change the color from here as well. You can make it red, whatever color you want, but we want white, so I'll select white from here. After that we have letter spacing. We don't want any letter spacing over here. You can add some line height. Okay, when you increase the line height, you'll see the there is some gap at top and bottom of this font. Okay, so you can increase or decrease some line height over here. After that we have text shadow. Now here we have used text shadow, so let's put some text shadow. Let's put the first one. Okay, you can see there are different design of shadows. Now let me select the first one. So I'm selecting the first one, and after that at the bottom we have the orientation, which is again center aligned. So I'll select center align from here. Fine, now this is looking exactly like this one. Okay, so let us click on OK. Now once you do any changes on your website, make sure to press the Control and S button so that you save all the changes, because whatever happens to your website, sometimes what happens is we create the whole website but we haven't made any changes, we haven't saved any changes that we have done. So what happens is something wrong happens, your computer shuts down or anything like that, and you lose all your changes. So you have to do everything from scratch again. So we don't want that. Whenever you do any changes, just press Control and S on your keyboard. All the changes will be saved. Fine. Okay, so after this, we have this beautiful divider over here. Let's add this one. So again, come back over here, hover this and click on this plus button, the black plus button. And now search for divider. Okay, so this is the one, divider. Now visibility, make it show divider. Now as you can see this thin white divider on your screen, I would recommend you guys to watch this video on a computer or on a laptop. Or if you're seeing this on a mobile phone, make sure you see it on full screen so that you can see everything more clearly. Okay, so that I can explain you more better. Okay, so we can see the divider now, but we'll again have to design this divider because we want to change the color, we want to change the width and everything. So come to design section, let's come to color. So select any color from here. Now you can select any color like red, green, blue, white, or you can add some custom color code over here. Okay, so after selecting the color, go to style, make sure it is solid. Okay, if you want dashed, you'll have dashed lines over here. As you can see, there are different styles. Now the one which we have used is just simple and solid design. After that we have divider position. Select vertically centered. Okay, then after that we have sizing. Let's first increase the width. As you can see, when you increase the width, it becomes more bolder. So I would recommend you to select something like maybe 6 pixels is looking fine. Okay, 6 pixels. Height, you can select any height you want. After that we have to decrease the width. Okay, as you can see, when I decrease the width, this is what happens. So I would recommend you guys to make it 15 pixels. And after that the alignment, make it center align. Okay, so this is really looking nice and this is really looking exactly like this one. After that click on OK, but we want the divider below this text, below the second text. So let's do that. Now select this divider and just drag it at the bottom. It is that simple. You can see the divider now has come below this second text. So this is also done. Now after that we have some simple text over here. Let's copy it from here and again click on this plus button, this black plus button. Again search for text, select this one and just paste in the text, or copy, or you can just type in the text. Go to design, text, the color should be light, okay, and let's increase the size to maybe 20 pixels. Rest everything is fine, just make it center align and click on OK. And again, drag this text at the bottom. Now, let me press Ctrl S so that all these changes are saved. Okay guys, so this is looking really amazing. Okay, so we are really going good. And I hope you guys can now see that how easy it is to create a website like this. We have not typed in any code or anything like that for now. It is just drag and drop thing. After that, we have this beautiful button. Now let's see how to create a button. Okay, so again, hover this and click on this plus button. And now search for button. This is the one. So then this time we'll be using the button module. Click on this. Now button text. As you can see here, the button says get started. So you can just type in get started. Fine. Now if you see over here, the button is has started showing. Okay, it says get started. But the style is really terrible. We'll have to change that. Now go to design. First one is alignment. So this is center align. So select center align. After that, we have text, which is dark. We don't want dark text. We want light. So select light. Now we can see the button is looking much better. After that, we have the button option. Select that. Now you have to make this thing on. Okay. It says use custom style for button. Make it on because we want our own style. As you can see, this button is looking very boring. We want something amazing like this one. So let's select this. And the first one is button text size. I think 20 is way bigger. Let us make it around 16 pixels. So I have put 16 pixels over here. Button text color, which is white, which is fine. Now button background color. If you see over here, we have some different background color. In fact, it is a combination of two color. At the left hand side, if I hope you guys can see this thing properly. At the left hand side, we have light yellow. And at the right hand side, we have dark yellow or something like orange kind of color. So let us again, if you select the first one, you can add only one color. So to add two different colors, select this one. Second one, click on OK. And for the first color, instead of blue, select this yellow color. And for the second color, you can select any color of your choice. So what I'll do is I'll drag my cursor to the section where we have some dark color, dark yellow color like this one. Fine. Okay, so we have a nice button over here. After that, just click on this thing, then come back again linear, and again we have to change the direction. We want the light color at the left hand side and the dark color at the right hand side. Here the light yellow color is at the top and the dark yellow color is at the bottom. So let's change the direction. Let's again make it around maybe 100 or 110, something like that. Then after that, come at the bottom. Then we don't want any border. So as you can see here, it says border width is 2 pixels and we have this white color border. We don't want that. So let's make it 0. Now we don't have any border and this is looking much better. Okay. Now let's see what we have to do. Now we have to give this different design to this button. You can see we have this radius from both the sides. Let's do that. Let's make it circular from both the sides. So here it is, button border radius. Now we'll have to increase these things. Now if you see, when I increase this, this button is becoming circular. Now this is looking nice. So what I'll do, I'll make it 50 pixels. And this is looking nice now. And let us add some letter spacing, maybe 1 pixel. Okay, 1 pixel is looking fine. After that, if you see over here, this text is all uppercase. You know, it's all capital letters. So let's select uppercase from here, select this button and it will make everything uppercase if you see over here. And when I hover over this button, you can see this icon, okay? But here when I hover this button, I don't see any icon. So I have to remove this icon. So I'll just make it no. I don't want to show any button icon, okay? After that, button hover text color. Okay, so if you see over here, when we hover this button, the text color changes to blue. So let's do that. Button hover text color. Let's make it blue. Now as you can see, when I hover this, it becomes blue. Rest everything is fine. Just go to spacing and let us add some space from both right and left hand side. So let us add padding of 20, maybe from both right and left. Okay, so we are adding 20 pixels right padding and 20 pixels left padding, and this is looking nice. Now let's add a shadow to the button, because if you see over here, we have a beautiful shadow here to the button. So let's add that. Select box shadow and select any kind of shadow you want. Okay, I'm selecting the first one. So everything is fine now. Just click on OK. Now let's drag this button at the bottom. Okay guys, so I think this is really looking nice. Okay, everything is going really nice. Now after that, let's add this divider, this beautiful divider at the bottom. Okay, so it is also very easy. However, this section, click on this gear icon, this row gear icon, row settings, go to design, and here you'll see these dividers. Select this, and we want to add a divider at the bottom of this section. Okay, so by default, top is selected. Select bottom from here. Now select the divider style. So let us see the divider style. I think this is the one. Select this one. Yeah, this is the one. Now we have to make some changes over here. Okay, we want to increase the height of the divider like this one. Okay, 230 maybe is looking fine. Okay, but if you see over here, the dividers thing is getting black. We don't want black. We have this white color in the background. Okay, so let's add white color so that everything looks normal. So first go to color. Let's see where it is. Here it is, divider color. Select this and select white. Now this is looking much, much better. Now click on OK. Now if you see below this button, we have a nice amount of gap, and then the divider ends. So adding a gap is really, really easy. Just hover over here, and when you see at the bottom, just add and drag it to the bottom. Okay, now this is how easy it is to add a gap in your website. As you can see here, this is really, really easy. Okay, so just add any amount of gap that you want and press Ctrl S so that you can save all the changes and you don't miss any changes. Okay, okay guys, so with this we have completed the first section. It was really fun creating the first section. Really easy, really fun. Now let's see how to create the second section. Okay, so this is the second section. Let's see how to do that. Come back over here. So first we'll have to add a new row. So to add a new row, you'll see this button at the bottom, this blue button, blue plus button. Click on that button. Now we'll have to select regular. Now number of columns that you want in this section. So as you can see over here, for this thing, we have only one column. Okay, this things is only one column. And after that, we have three different columns. For now, just one column. So select one column from here. The first thing that we have to add is a text. So again, search for text module. Fine. Now let's paste in, or let's type in small business over here. Okay, let me type in small business. Fine, so we can see small business over here. Now go to design, select text, and the color is dark or light. It doesn't matter because we have to change the color. Okay, the text font, you can change any font. I just want the default font, and let's make it ultra bold. As you can see, this thing is ultra bold. The small business text is ultra bold, and let's make it uppercase. As you can see, it is all small letters, small, smaller case, lower case. Let's make it uppercase. Let's press this icon. Now, as you can see, everything is uppercase. Now let's increase the size to maybe 120. Okay, so just type in 120px 120 pixels. Now if you see over here, this color is something like, you know, light blue color. So let's add that color. Let's select text color. Let's select the blue color first. You'll see this is a very dark blue color. Now there is a very nice trick to, you know, make it lighter. What you can do is, you can see that two different lines over here. Select the second line and drag it to the bottom, and you can make it anything, you know, you can just disappear it, or you can make it lighter according to you. So I think this is looking nice. Okay, okay, this much. Okay, so fine, this is looking nice. Fine, so after that, what we have to do, we have to make it center align. So select this thing, center align. Fine, now let's click on okay. So we have this thing over here. Okay, we have this text over here. Now if you might have noticed that this text is looking bigger than this website. Now it is not because we have increased this size. It is because this demo website is at 80% zoom, And this website, the website which we are creating, is at 100% zoom. Okay, I have zoomed it so that I could show you guys more clearly. You can see everything. You don't have to do anything on your video. I just did it 100% zoom so that you can see everything clearly. Okay, so it is not big. It is actually the same size. Now let's add this text, local biz agency. Okay, so let's add this. Again, come back over here and now click on this black plus button to add a new module. And again, search for text. Select text, type in any text you want. So we can see this local biz agency over here. Go to design, select text. And let's see, this is also, I think, ultra bold. Okay, so let's select ultra bold from here. And let's increase this size to maybe, okay, this is not size, I'm sorry. Here it is. Okay, here it is, sorry, text size, let's make it 60 pixels. Okay, that was 120, let's make it 60 pixels. And let's change the color to maybe something like this, dark blue. Okay, you can make it more darker, you can just, you know, drag these things from here. And after that, just make it center align. Fine. Okay, so this is how you do this and click on OK. Oh yeah, so this is how this is looking nice. Now after that, let's see what we have. After that, we have this divider. Now we don't have to create this divider again. Okay, it will take some time. So what I can do is I can just hover over this divider and click on this icon which says duplicate module. Now as you can see, we don't even have to create this divider. This is that easy. You know, it will save a lot of time when you are going to create your website. Now what I can do is I can just drag this divider and put it below this one. Okay, so this is really, really amazing. We don't have to create any divider or so. Now there is one more awesome step. What you can do is you can in fact save this divider. Okay, so let me show you how. You can just hover this divider and select this icon which says save module to library. Click on that. You can give it any name. So let me give it a name of small divider. Okay, small divider, click on save to library. Now we can use this divider anywhere on your website by using the library thing. Okay, after this divider we have some simple text. So let's copy this text from here. Let's add a new module. Let's click on this button, search for text module. Okay, add some text, go to design. Okay, go to text. Let's increase this size maybe to 20 pixels, fine. And center align, I think it is okay. Yeah, it is two different lines. Okay, so let us go back to content, text. Let's add a line after this one. Maybe let's add a line after this. Let's press enter. Fine. Now if you see, there is very small amount of gap between the lines, so let us increase that. Go to design again, go to text. Now increase this thing, text line height. Okay, as you can see now there is a nice amount of gap between the lines. Click on OK. Now drag this text at the bottom. Okay, or you can just drag this divider at the top. It will do the same things. Okay guys, so we are done with this section as well. Okay, we had these things. Now if you see one thing, if you notice one thing, this three things, this title, this divider and this simple text is used many different times. Let us see the next section. Okay, here also we have this title, divider and text. After that again we have title, divider and text. So what we can do is we can save this section, the whole section, into a library so that we don't have to create this section again and again. We can just use the saved layout. Okay, so let's do that. Let's come back to this page and let us do one thing. Okay, now hover this section, okay, this green section. Now click on this button, save module. Let's give it a name. Let's give it a name of title. Okay, because this is title, just let's select title. Click on save to library. Now we can use this title, this whole section, again and again on our website, so we don't have to create it again. Okay, so you can just press Ctrl S so that you don't miss any changes. Okay guys, so let's come back over here. Let's see what we have next. So we have three different services. We have a image, title and some text. So this is also very easy. Okay, now there are two ways of creating it. Okay, first what you can do is I'll show you the easiest way, but let me explain you first. First is to add three different modules. So first you'll have to add an image module, you'll have to add this image, then you'll have to text module, then you can add this text, then again you'll have to add another text module and you can add this thing. So that is a quite I don't recommend that step. Now there is an easy way of creating this thing, and that is by using a module called blurb. So let's see how to do that. First, let's add a new column or a new row. So now this time what we have to do, we have to click on this button, the green plus button, select this and select three different columns, because as you can see we have three different services over here. Now let's search for blurb and let's select this one. Okay, so we have this thing over here. The first thing is title. What is the title here? The title is service one. So let's type in service one. Fine. After that we have the text. What is the text? So let's see. Let's copy this text from here. Okay, let me copy it from here and let's paste it over here. Okay, so we can see the title, the text over here. Then when you scroll down, you'll see this link. So you can link the image and the title to any page you want. So what I'll do is, instead of this URL bar, I'll just paste in, or I'll just type in this hash sign, the hashtag sign. And you can see where this link opens, whether this link opens in the same tab or a new tab. You can also select that. Now let's add an image. Okay, so select this image. You can use an icon also if you want. We'll see how to use an icon in different page. This time you have to use an image, but I have shown how to use an icon as well in the later part of this video. So stay tuned. Okay, first let's add an image. Now before adding an image, now there are many different images that I have used in this website, so I'll be giving you guys all the images for free. You don't have to do anything. You'll see a link in the video description below. Click on that link and you can download all the images, all the files that I have used on this website. You can download everything for free. Okay, so once you download it, you can just upload all the images from there. So let me upload the first image, this image, this guy with a notepad or something. So let's click on upload, click on upload files, select files, and you'll see something like this. You'll see a folder called media and you'll have all the files over there. So first thing is, let me search over here. Okay, this is the image, this service one image. Select this, click on open, click on upload a new image, and you can see the image over here. Okay, it's the exact same image. Okay, now after that we have background thing. We don't have to put any background color. As you can see, there's no background color over here. Go to design, image and icon. First let's add some more effects to the image. Okay, first is to add a shadow. So yes, we want to add a shadow, so I'll select this shadow. Now you can see there's a nice amount of shadow below the image. You can add these kind of shadows as well, but I'm selecting this first one. This is the most amazing one. You can also change the shadow color. For example, you can make it red. Now you can see there is red shadow below that image. Okay, but I will not like to do that. I'll just, if you want to make it default, select this color code and just delete it. Okay, it will become default. Then after that, I want to do one thing. I want to, you know, round the corners of this image. So what I can do, I can just type in maybe 20 pixels. And again, as you can see, now the corners are rounded. If you increase this number, it will get more rounded. For example, if you make it 100, now as you can see, this is how the image will look like. So I don't want it something like this. I'll just type in 20. And this is looking amazing. Okay, better than this one, I guess. Here we don't have the rounded corners. So you have all the options. If you want to make it rounded corners, you can make it. If you want to make it normal, you can just make it zero. Okay. We don't want to use any border to this image, so let's ignore all these steps and let's go directly to this title text. Now here we can do some changes to the title. So the first thing that we have to do is make it uppercase. So we can click on this button. Now as you can see, everything is uppercase. Now we can increase the size. Let's make it maybe around 30 pixels. Yeah, it is looking nice. You can also change the color if you want. I think it is it is the same color. We don't have to change the color. I think 30 is quite bigger, or maybe it is fine. You can select any text size you want. I am selecting 30. After that, let's okay, fine. Let's make it center aligned. Here it is, alignment button. Let's make it center aligned. Then after that, select body text. Now let's do some changes in the body text. Let's increase the size to maybe 16 would be fine. Yeah, 16 is looking better. And let's again make it center align. Select this alignment. Okay, so this is looking better. So we have the text service one, and then we have this text. Okay, exactly like this website. So just click on OK. Now we don't have to create blurbs again and again. What we can do is you can just copy this thing two times and drag it over here. Again, drag this thing over here. Now instead of service 2, if you want to make any changes, just select this, make it 2. Just select this, make it 3. And if you want to change the image, select this gear icon. Go to the image section, click on upload image. Select the image you want to upload. So let me upload all the images at once. Okay. Click on open. And this one is this Mac image. So let me select this one. Here it is. Select this image, click on upload image. You can see the changes. Click on OK. Now let's upload the third image. Click this gear icon. Let's scroll down, go to image section, upload. And this time it is this one. Select this, click on upload an image. Click on OK. Okay guys, so this is looking really amazing. So with this, we have also completed the second section. So within few minutes, we have completed two sections, and both the sections are really looking amazing, really looking awesome. Okay. So similarly, let's create the third section. Again, come back to this page. Now click on this plus button, blue plus button, click on regular. And here this time we have two different columns. So select two columns. Now in the first column, first we have is a single text, a simple text. So search for text module, select this, and here it says, how can we help you? So just copy this text from here. Let's paste it over here. Okay, you can see this text is showing over here. Now let's design it. Let's go to text. Okay, the style, the color is light, but we'll keep it dark for now. Let's increase the size maybe to, okay, maybe 35 is looking better, 35 pixels. And let's make it bolder. So instead of regular, let's select bold. And let's see what we have next. Okay, rest everything is fine. We just have to change the color. So let's make it color dark. Instead of color dark, let's make it light. Now that thing is disappeared. That is fine. Click on OK. Now again, we have to change the background color for this one. Okay. So again, click on this gear icon for this row settings and go to background. Go to this option, the second option. You can also use any image in the background. You can use a video in the background. You can use anything you want. Okay. But I want to use a combination of two different colors. So I'll select the second one, click on add new, and we can see two different colors over here. Now this time we don't have to make any changes because here we have at the top, we have the blue, and at the bottom we have the green, which is fine. We don't have to make any changes over here. Just make it okay. And we'll add these dividers later on. Okay, we have two different dividers. We'll see how to add them later on. Okay, first let's add this divider. Okay, so this time I have told you we don't have to do it again. It is really easy. Just click on this add button, and instead of selecting any new module, just go to add from library, and you'll find this small divider which we have added to library. Select this. Now one thing that we have to do is increase the percentage, because here we had set 15%. Now this was one single column. For one single column, this is what a 15% looks like. It is quite bigger. But because here we have the column is quite smaller, because we have two different columns, the size is become smaller. Also, we have to make it left aligned. So let's do that. Select or hover this divider and click on this gear icon. Go to design and go to sizing. And now instead of 15%, let's make it 30%, looking fine. And let's change the alignment to left. Okay, so this is looking fine. Let's make it 30%. From here, fine. Click on OK. After that, we have some simple text. Let me copy this text from here. Okay, fine. Again, come back over here, click on this plus button, click on this black plus button to add a new module. Search for text, select this, paste in the text, go to design, let's change the text color to white or to make it light. Then we have font size, let's make it 16, and let's increase the line height maybe to 1.8. yeah, 1.8 is looking fine. After that, what we have after that, we have these things. Okay, we have some icon at the left hand side and a title at the right hand side. So this is also very easy. First click on OK. Now again click on this plus button, black plus button, to add a new module, and again search for blurb. Okay, so we'll use the blurb again, but we'll use this time this module in a different way. First give it a title. You can see the title is showing. Go to design, and in fact we also have to use a icon. Okay, this is an icon which you see at the left hand side. So let's select image and icon, and let's make it yes. Use icon, make it yes, and you can select the icon you want. So we are using this tick mark icon. So let's search for that. Okay, you can search it from here. Okay, we have it. We have one over here, but this is not the one, I guess. Okay, let me search. Okay, here it is. Select this one. Now as you can see, this icon is showing now. Now we'll have to change the design of this icon. So don't worry, go to design first. Select image and icon. Let's change the icon color to something like this. Okay. And you can increase or decrease the transparency and everything. And after that, we don't want to make it circle, don't worry. And we have to change the placement of the icon. And we, instead of top, we want to make it left. Okay. Now we can see the icon is showing at the left. This is looking much better. Now after that, we have the text, but instead of simple text, we want to change the title text, because this is the title or outstanding service. So go to title text, and let's do one thing. Let's change the color to white. Okay, first let's make it bolder. So select instead of regular, make it bold. And if you see over here, the title is quite above and the image is over here, the icon is over here. So let's fix this. To fix this, you can add some line height. It will solve the problem. Okay, as you can see, I'm adding 2 em line height, and this looks that, oh, maybe not 2 em, let's make it 1.8, and this is looking better. Click on OK. Okay, so this is looking much better. Now again, we don't have to create it again and again. We can just hover this thing. Okay, let's hover this and click on this button. Okay. Now as you can see, it has copied 2-3 times. Now there is one small problem which I see. There is a lot of gap between all these things. Now there is also a very easy trick to solve this. Select the first one, hover the first one, click on gear icon, go to design. Now go to spacings, and you have this custom margin. So go to custom margin, and in the bottom text select 0. Now as you can see, this space has decreased. Okay, now delete these things. Okay, now again copy this. Okay, now the space is nice. Okay, now we have decent amount of space over here. So we have added and we have created the first section. Now let's create this beautiful section, the form section. So again, come back to this page and click on this add module and search for contact form. This is the one, contact form module. Select this. Now by default, this is how it looks. Okay, we have to change the look. First, we'll have to give it a title which says get in touch. So let's give it a title. If you see over here in the text section, we have title. Give it a title. You can see the title over here. You can also add a successful message, success message. Whenever someone fills in this form and the form is successfully sent to you, what happens? You can give them some message like thank you for filling out this form, something like that. Now submit button text. Here it says submit, and here also it says submit, which is fine. So you can just leave this, or you can change this thing if you want. Okay, you can just type anything you want over here. After that, we have email. Make sure you have your email over here. Okay, so I'm putting my email over here. And go to this message pattern, and you'll see all these things. Okay, instead of this phone number, you have this phone number, you have this field ID, and all these things over here. The message, phone number. I'll show you these things later on. This is very important, by the way. Okay, element. You have this captcha thing over here. You see this captcha thing. So whenever someone wants to send some message, submit some message, they will have to solve this simple captcha. For example, 1 plus 15 is 16. So they'll have to type in 16. If they don't type this and they click on submit, the form will not be filled and it will not be sent. Okay, this is basically to avoid spammers and bots, you know, to spam your inbox and something like that. Then after that, we have the background image, background section. We'll see these things later on. First, let's see these things. Okay, first we have the name. But here if you see, the name is a full width section. We have this full width box, but here it is 50% name and 50% email address. So first we'll have to fix that. So select this gear icon for name, okay, and go to text, which is fine. Name, ID, title, name, field options, input field, okay, fine, which is fine. For normal names and everything, we select input field. If you want them to put in their email address, you can put email address. Now, why it is important to select this? Because if you select email address and they don't put a decent email address or the correct email address pattern, then they will get an error. For example, instead of email address, they are trying to, if they try to put in their name, and in name use spaces to differentiate your first name and last name, you use something like that, so they can get an error if that doesn't look like the email format, like, you know, something like nayer@gmail.com. so that it should look something like that. So it is important. Okay, after that, go to design, select layout, and select make full width. Yes. Okay, now we can see this is full width section. Okay, now again click on okay. Now go to email section, go to design, and make it full width. Again click on OK. Now after this section, we have one additional section, which is phone number. So let's add that. So to add that, click on this add. Now go to text, field ID, just type in phone. In the title, type in phone number. Okay, so whatever you type in the title, you can see this in the placeholder over here. Now field option, what is this? What do you want the user to fill in over here? So we want them to enter some number. So we don't have any option for that. You can just select input field for that. Okay, allowed symbols, if you, do you want to allow them symbols or only numbers? So we want them to allow only numbers. So I'll select numbers only. Is this field required? If this is not required, if you want the user, even if they don't fill in the phone number, you can accept the form, then you can just make this no. Or if you want to make this thing require, you can make it yes. Okay, so click on okay. But what we want is we want the phone number above this message section, so we can drag this thing above over here. And I don't want this captcha thing, so what I'll do is I'll select elements and I'll make this thing off, display captcha. Now go to design. It's time to change some designing things. So from here, first again go to content, and first let's add some, you know, this background color. As you can see, there's a beautiful background color over here. First let's add that. So select this background color, and you can add any background color. For example, if you want to add black, you can see this is how it will look. You can add any background color. So what I'll do is I'll add this color. Okay, this is looking nice. Now this is not looking that good at present because we don't have any padding or so. You'll understand these things later on. First go to design. First let's change the design for this thing, get in touch, the title section. Okay, here this is how the title looks. It has got a beautiful yellow color and all these things. So go to title text and let's change the design. Okay, instead of regular, let's make it bold, center align, and let's change the color to yellow. Okay, or you can change this color to whatever you like. I'm changing this to yellow, and this is looking nice. Okay, so we are done with the title text. After that, select form field text. Okay, for this single fields. And form field background color, if you see over here, we have a dark blue kind of background color over here. So select form field background color, and you can select any background color like this. Okay, for example, you can have this color, or you can change this color to anything you want. Okay, and when you change this color, if you see the these titles are not looking nice. So what we can do is we can change this title. For example, here it says name, then after that it says email address. We can change these things. Okay, In fact, it is really important to change these things because it is not looking nice. So again, go to form fields and let's scroll down. Now here it is, form field text color. Let's make it white. Now it is looking much better, and rest everything is looking fine. Now go to spacing and let's add padding of maybe 35 from all the sides. Okay, now as you can see, the form is looking much better. So that is this use of spacing. After that, let's make some changes to this thing, to this button. Okay, so let's find button section. Here it is, button. If you see over here, the button is very simple. Okay, very simple button. The color is blue, and when you hover that, it becomes yellow, and the text is white. So let's do that. Make this thing yes, custom style for button. And first button text color, let's select white. Let's change the size. Let's make it quite smaller. Maybe 15 is better. Button background color, let's make it blue, looking better. Border width, we don't want any white border, so we can just delete this. Then after that, radius, let's make it a bit circular. So you can select, you can make it 50 pixels radius. It will become circular button. And if you see, when we hover this, we want the color of the background to change to yellow. So let's see that. Here it is, button icon color, or button hover text color, button hover background color. So this is what we have to change, button hover background color. Let's make it yellow. Now as you can see, when I hover this, it becomes yellow. And you can also do one thing, when the background becomes yellow, you can change the text to white. So we have this button hover text color, you can select black. Now as you can see, in the normal state, the background color is blue, the text color is white, but when we hover this, the background becomes yellow, text becomes black. So it's all up to you. Okay, once you do all these changes, just click on OK. You can also add some shadow to this contact form, and in fact you should add, because this is really looking nice. Now to add these things, I have given a very simple one line of CSS code. You will find that code also in the video description below. There is a link, you can download all the files. In that file, you will find all the images, all the files. You will also find this file. Okay, let me show you the file. Okay, this is the file. Okay, you will find this file. You will see all these things over here. And here you have this section under form. You have this CSS for this one. You have to just have to copy this line, box shadow. Okay, copy this line, come back to your website. Here it is, click on edit, go to advanced and go to custom CSS, main element, and paste it. Now as you can see, we have a beautiful shadow to this contact form, and it is really looking amazing. Now let's press Ctrl S to save all the changes. Now it's time to add this beautiful divider, okay, from both top and bottom. So let's do that. Let's hover this blue section, go to design, divider. First, let's add a top divider. So select a divider and let's search for that one. I think it is this. Okay, not this one. It is single layer. We want the double layer one, which is, I guess, this. I don't know. Okay, not this one. Let's search again. Okay, this is the one, I guess. Select this. Yeah, here it is. And select the divider color as white. Okay, so this is how it is looking. Very nice. Now go to bottom, select this bottom. Again, select a divider style. Let's scroll down. And let's search. Okay, I think. Okay, let me search. This is the one, I guess. Yeah, it is the one. Again, change the color to white, but we want different kind over here. Okay, not this is not the one, I'm sorry. Again, let's select this thing, and I guess this one. Select this. Now we have to do some changes over here. What you can do, you have this divider flip, select the first button and again select the second button. Okay, now as you can see, this thing is flipped. First, click on OK. You can see the changes over here. Okay, this is how this look and this is how this looks. Now let's add some gap over here. So just hover here and drag it to the bottom. You have some gap at the top. Same thing over here. Hover here, drag it to the bottom. We have some gap from the bottom as well. Now just press Ctrl S so that you don't miss any changes. Now this section is also done. So we have successfully created this section as well, and this is really looking amazing. Let me zoom out a bit so that you can see. Okay, first section, second section, and third section. Fine, let's see what we have next. So we have this section after that. So this is very easy. First, we'll have to copy this thing. We have added this, we have saved this in our library, so it is really easy. And after that, we'll have to create this section. So let's do that. Again, click on this plus button, the blue plus button, to add a new section. And first, we want a simple section, a single column. Now again, to add a new row, just click on this blue plus button, regular. Now instead of selecting any columns, a number of columns, what you can do, go to add from library, and we have added this title section, select title. Now as you can see, without doing anything, we have the complete section over here. Okay, this section, we have it over here. Let's add some gap at the top first. Okay, nice amount of gap. And after that, we can easily change that. Okay, first it says what we do. Okay, so instead of small businesses, we can type in what we do, as you can see. And instead of this, we can type in why choose us. So just copy it from here. You can, or you can just select this and type in why choose us. It's all up to you. Fine, so this is looking much better. And after that, let's add this section now. So again, what we can do is we can add a new row, because here we'll have to add two different columns. So we can add a new row, click on this green plus button, add new row, select two rows or two columns. The first one, we have a title, subtitle or some text and a button. So let's add a title first. Let's add some text. Select this one. Let me copy it from here. Title. And there is, now let me show you a very easy way. Okay, what you can do is you can paste this thing over here. Now select this text, and from here select anything like heading 2, heading 3. Okay, so what I'm doing is I'm selecting heading 3, and in this same section, copy this code as well, this text as well, and paste it over here. Okay, now as you can see, this is how it is looking. We have this title and we have this paragraph. And make sure this is simple paragraph. Okay, select this and make sure it is simple paragraph. It is not heading or anything like that. So in the same, using the same setting, text setting, we can design both this section or this text, the title text and the paragraph text, which is very, very useful and very amazing. Okay, so let's go to design. Let's first select the heading text. And let's increase the size, or maybe we don't need to increase the size. In fact, we have to decrease the size. Okay, it was heading 3. If you remember, we had put in heading 3. So first we'll have to select heading 3. Now we'll have to decrease the size, maybe to 20 pixels. Okay. Okay, let's make it 20 pixels. After that, let's make it bolder. Instead of regular, select bold. Let's change the color of this to yellow. Okay, we'll have to change the background color. Okay, now it is not looking nice, so we can just ignore that for now. After that, what we have? Okay, so this is done for heading. After that, we have this section, simple white color. So let's, okay, minimize this heading text. And now let's go to first section, simple text. Now instead of size 14, let's make it 15 or 16 pixels. Okay, 16 pixels. Let's increase some line height. Let's make it 1.8. It is looking better. Fine. And let's make it white. Now, once we make it text color white, it will disappear, obviously. Okay, as you can see, it has disappeared, which is fine. Click on OK. Now we'll have to add this button. Now, if you see, this button is very much similar to this one. So we don't have to click, create it again. We can just easily copy this button, or we can simply save this button to library. So just save this button to library. Let's name it button. Let's type button. Click on add to library. And now we can use this button over here. Just click on this plus button, add from library, select button, and we have it over here. We just have to decrease the size. So select this, go to design, text, and we also have to make it left aligned, by the way. So first, let's go to button, decrease the size to maybe 12, and let's make it left aligned. Let's see the alignment option. I think it is at the top. Let's find the alignment option. Here it is at the top alignment. Let's make it left aligned. Fine. Click on OK. Now after that, let's add this background color so that we can see everything more properly. First, click on Ctrl and S to save all the settings. Now there is a small change over here. Earlier, what we used to do, we wanted to add a background color to the whole section. For example, if you see the background color is applied to the whole section. Here also, the background color is applied to the entire section. But here if you see, the background color is not applied to the complete section, it is just applied to this column, okay? So we'll see how to do that. Let's see how to do that. Come back over here. Now instead of selecting the section setting, we'll have to select the column setting. So how over here and click on this gear icon for the green section, the row settings. Select this, go to background. Now you will see many different options like background 1, column 1 background and column 2 background. So for the column 1 background, we want multicolor or dual color. So we'll select this and we'll select this one. Okay, now as you can see, we have this background color over here. And for the column 2, we want an image in the background. As you can see, there is an image in the background. So what we can do, we can scroll down. We have column 2 background. Select the third option, which is for image. Click on add new image. And let's upload that image. And let me find that. Okay, so I think this is the one. Select this image, click on open. Okay, click on upload an image. Okay, as you can see, we have this image in the background. So first we'll have to do some changes. First, let's make it parallax effect. As you can see in the demo website, the image is having the parallax effect. So let's make it on column 2 parallax effect. Okay. Now go to design. First thing is to add some spacing, because as you can see, there is no space at all over here. We can see all the thing touching the corners. So we need some space. So go to spacing and let's add custom padding for column 1. Okay. So maybe 20, I think, or maybe 35 will be fine. 35 padding from all the sides. Okay, so this is looking much better. 35 padding from all the sides. Now after that, what we can do is, in fact, I think this is quite more, not 35. So let me do one thing. Let us increase the top and bottom padding to 50. Okay, so let's increase the top and bottom padding to 50. Now this is, I think, looking much better. After doing this, if you see, there is a gap between both the columns. So we don't want any gap here. We don't have any gap between the columns. So what we can do is, we can minimize this. Now go to sizing, and if you see, there is an option which says use custom gutter width. Make that on and make the gutter to 1. Okay, and click on OK. Now similarly, we can create the next row. This is the second row. Now we don't have to do it again. It is really easy. Just copy this, duplicate this row, and you have this thing over here. Now we just have to do one thing. Let's decrease all the gap between over here. Okay. Now as you can see, it is looking much better. And we have to do one thing. We have to change the background color for these things. Okay. So select this option, row setting for the second one, go to background. And here this time we don't want this color in the first section. Just delete it. And we want an image in the first section. So select this image and let's upload the image. This one, click on OK. So this time we have the image in the background for the first column. Okay, and we want color in the second column. So select color 2, column 2, and delete this image. Select this color, click on OK. Fine. Now we can drag these things over here, this text and everything. We can also drag this button over here, and let's add some spacing, some padding to this. So again, select this column, go to design, go to spacing, and let's add column 2 spacing, top 50, right and left 35, and bottom also 50. Fine. Click on OK. So this is how it is looking. I think it is looking great. Okay. Exactly like this. Okay, Now let's add some gap over here at the top, and let's also some gap at the bottom. Fine, this is looking better. Now after that we have this section, this testimonial section. Again, this is very easy section. Again, click on this plus button, blue plus button, and select regular. And again, we don't have to select any single row or double row, because again we have used this section, the section which we have already saved in our library. So we don't have to create it, we just have to add it from library. So click on add from library and select title from here. Okay, so we have this section over here. Now we'll have to make some changes over here. We want to make all this thing to white. As you can see, the color of this text is different, and we want to add background color, some different background color over here. So let's do that. Let's add a background color to this section. So click on this section setting, background, and go to dual color, select it, and this is looking better. Click on OK. Let's add some gap at the top. Fine. Now let's change the color. First, let's change this color. Let's go to design, text. Let's make it light. Okay. And let's change this color as well. The title color, design, text, color light. Okay, not this one maybe. Okay, this is for this one, the background one. Okay, this one. So we can change this color as well if you want. Select this color and let's make it more lighter, or you can select white and let's make it more lighter. Okay, lighter white. Click on OK. Now select this color, the dark blue color. Go to design, text, and select this and make it white. Okay, like this one. And we have also given a shadow to this one, to this white color. So you can also do that. You can select any shadow from here. Okay. I'm selecting the first one. Click on OK. So this is looking amazing. Click on Control S to save the settings. Now after that, we have this testimonial thing. Let's do that. So click on Add New Row, because we have two different columns over here. Select two columns and add or search for a module called testimonial. Okay, let me search. Here it is, testimonial module. Select this. Now the author name, here the author name is John, so just type in John. After that we have the designation, which is CEO, and the company name. Okay, so job title CEO, company name. Okay, after that what we have over here, then we have the text, this the testimonial or the testimony of this person. Copy that and paste it under this content. Fine. Then we also have an image, so go to image, upload an image, and let's upload the image from here. This is the one. Let's upload both the image at once and let's select this one. Click on upload an image. So we have the image over here. Now it's time to do some changes. So go to design, quote icon. First, we don't need this icon at the top, so I'll just remove the quote icon. I don't need it. Okay, first we'll have to do it from here. Go to content, elements, and don't show quote icon. Now go to design, text. Okay, instead of light, let's make it dark. Okay, so we have all the dark text. And let's do one more thing. Okay, go to body text. Let's increase the size maybe to 16, and let's change the font. Instead of default font, I'll select Nunito font, NUNITO. This is looking much better. And what do we have next? Image, select the image. Okay, image is fine. Now again go to design and scroll down and go to border, and let's increase, let's add some rounded corners. So let's add 20 or maybe 50. Let's see. Okay, so 50 is looking better. Let's add 50, and let's add some spacing as well. So go to spacing. Let's add some padding at top and bottom, maybe 50 pixels, both top and bottom. Click on OK. Okay, so this is looking amazing. Click on or press Control S to save the changes. Okay, exactly like this one. Now again, we don't have to create it again, just copy it or duplicate it and drag it over here. Now from here also you can change the image, you can change the name. For example, instead of John, if you want, you can just type in Nayar. Okay, instead of CEO, you can type anything like manager, whatever you want. Okay, you can do it easily. After that, what do we have? Now if you see over here at the bottom, we have this divider, beautiful divider. Let's do that. Let's add this divider. So select this, or instead of this, what I'll do is, I'll not add this divider to this bottom. I'll add a divider at the top of this section, the bottom section, because we'll be using this section throughout the website, and we'll have this divider attached to this section. That will be much better. Okay, so just press Ctrl S and let's add the last divider. Okay, last section. Again click on add new section. Now again click on regular and don't add a row, just click on add to library and select title. So we have the title and everything over here. Because it is looking very much similar, we just don't have this thing, the background text. So let's delete this. Fine. So here it says let's work together, so we can just type in let's work together. Fine. Okay, and if you see, the color of this is white and the color of this text is also white, and at the bottom we have this button. So let's add all these things. First, let's change the color of this bottom text to white. Go to design, text, instead of color dark, select color light, click on OK. For this text as well, select this, design, text, color light. Okay, this is the title, so here it is, text color, make it light. Okay, we also have a shadow, so let's select this shadow. Okay, click on OK. And at the bottom we have a button, so click on add new module, add from library, and select this button. And let's add this background color over here. So select this background, select this one. Okay, click on okay. Fine, so this is looking better. Let's add some gap at top and at bottom. Now if you see over here, we want this divider at the top, so let's do that. Let's select this thing, go to design, go to divider, and select top. Now let's select that. This is the one. Okay, select it. And I think it is looking better. You can increase these things. Let's increase the divider height if you want. And let's make it this way. Okay, I've flipped this divider. This is looking better. And let's add the color instead of black to white. So divider color, select white. Okay, so white is also not working. What actually we have to do is, we have to get this color code. Okay, so first let's click on okay. Let's add some gap at the top so that, okay, this is looking better. And let's see what is the color code for this one. So let's click on edit row, design, or not design, background, and let's select the second color. Okay, so this is the color code. I hope you can see. Just copy it from here and come at the bottom. Again, click on this edit row, back design, divider, color, and paste in this color. Okay, as you can see now, this is matching. So this is how you do it. Okay guys, so after doing all these settings, what we can do is, we can just click on OK and press Ctrl and S to save all the changes. Fine. After that, we have this section. We'll do this thing later on. This is the footer section, and we'll also have to change this thing, the bottom footer bar. So we'll see how to do that thing later on. First, we'll have to create this thing. Now we have successfully created our home page, but there is one more thing left, and that is the animations. Okay, first let me refresh this home page, the demo website, so that we can see the animation. Now as you can see, there is an animation to this, and whenever I scroll down, you'll see all these animations. Okay, so let's add this animation. So first, there are different ways. If you want, you can add animation to one single modules or to complete row. Okay, so what I'll do for the first one, I won't add animation to single modules. I'll add it to the complete row. So I'll select this complete row, go to design, and at the bottom you'll see animation. Now you can select anything like fade in and you'll see the animation. You can select slide, okay, you can select bounce, whatever. So I'm selecting slide for this one, it is looking better. Now let's select the second one. Now this time we'll add different animation to different thing. For example, for the first section, let's select this, go to design, go to animation, let's select fade or maybe slide. Okay, for the second also, this one, local agency, let's go to design, animation, and let's make it slide. Okay, now for the divider, I'll have to select some different. So what I'll do, I'll go to module setting, design, animation, and for this I'll select slide, but I'll change the direction. Okay, animation direction, it was center. I want the slider to come from right. Okay, the divider to come from right, as you can see. So I'll select left. Okay, because when you select left, it comes from right. Let me show you again. Okay, let's see. Okay, when I select left, as you can see, this is coming from right. Now for this last one, let's select design, animation, and let's select fold. Okay, so this is how it looks. So similarly, you can give animation to all these things, to all these different sections and different things, whatever you like, however you like. I don't want to, you know, go ahead and do animation for all these things. That will take a lot of time. I just wanted to show you guys how you can do this animation so that you can easily do it. Now there are a few things left, like the footer, and we have to make this header thing. We have to make it transparent. We have to add some menus. We'll see those things later on. First, what we'll do is, first we'll create all the different pages like about us, services, blog, and all these pages. And after that, we'll see how to create this menu and the footer. Fine. So we are done with the home page. You can click on this button which says exit Visual Builder. Okay guys, so this is how your page is looking. As you can see, all the animations. Now you won't see any animation over here because we haven't done any animation over here, but everything is looking nice. Okay, so we are done with this section or with this page. Now let's create a new page. So hover this new and click on page. Now let's see the next page, which is the about us page. Let's click on about us. Okay, so this is how our about us page is looking. So let's add the title as about us. Click on use the DB builder, visual builder. Okay, first we'll have to add this section. Now from here, I'll have to go a little bit faster because we have already seen how to use all the modules and everything. So I'll have to go a little bit faster so that we can cover all the pages. I want to show you guys all the pages, because if the time exits, then I'll just have to show you using the layouts, which I don't want. I want to show you how to create all the different pages. Okay, so first let's come back over here. So again, come back over here. Let's see, it is loading. First, let's add this section, very easy. Again, click on this, edit section, background. Click on add new, go to design now, and divider, bottom. Select any kind of the divider you want, and let's see what we have. We have this one. So it is, this is the one. Now for the color, we'll select white. Fine, click on OK. Let's add some gap at the bottom. Okay, like this. Okay, looking better. Fine. And let's add, increase the divider size. So again, go to divider, bottom. Let's increase the divider height. Okay, to maybe 220 pixels. Click on OK. And after that, we have this thing. Okay, so we don't have to create different text and give it all the styling, because we have already done that. We have a section, we can easily copy that section from here, title section. So click on add new row, add from library, click on title. Now we don't need this divider and everything, so we can delete all these things now, but we can use these things. Okay, okay, so these things, so let's drag it over here. Okay, first we'll have to add a column. So select this, select single column. Now we can drag this thing over here, drag it, this as well, drag it over here. Okay, let's make it at the bottom. Fine, so this is looking better. Now let's change this to about us and our story. So let's make it about us, not this one, this one. let's make it about us, and let's make this thing, the background thing, as our story. And let's change the colors, so it's all white. So let's change the color of this about us. Go to design, text, change the color to light, or maybe you'll have to change it from your text color, make it white. Let's add some shadow, click on OK. Let's add the background text color to white as well. So select text, select this, select white, looking better, click on OK. Let's decrease the gap. I think there is a lot of gap over here. Okay, this is looking better. Click on save changes. Let's delete this section, delete this row, we don't need this. Fine. Okay, I think let's add some more. Okay, this is looking better. Now after that we have this. First let's do one thing, let's save this complete row, because we'll be using this same thing again and again. So let's save this thing, let's add this section to the library, and let's name it header. Click on save to library, so we can use this header in all the pages. After that we have two different columns. Okay, the first column there is a simple image, then text and a button. So click on this blue plus button which says add new section, regular section, two columns, because we have two different columns. In the first column we just have a simple image, so we'll search for image module, upload image, and I think this is the one, upload an image. Okay, fine. And we don't have to do anything else. If you want, you can add some shadow to make it more awesome, more attractive. Okay, you can add some shadow, you can add some, you know, border radius and all those things if you want, you know, rounded corners. You can, if you add 20, it will become something like this. It's all up to you. Then we have these things, we have text, okay, title text, simple text, and a button. So again, click on this, add new, set search for text area, select this. And first let's add a title, okay, which is about. So let's type in about over here, and let's select this, and instead of paragraph let's make it heading 2. After that we have simple text, simple paragraph text, so we can just copy it from here and paste it over here. So we can now design all these things differently. So go to design. First select heading text, and it was heading 2, so select heading 2, and let's make it bolder. So select regular, make it bold. Okay, you can increase the size if you want. Let's increase the size to 35 pixels. Let's change the color to blue like we have in our demo website. Okay, let's add some line height so that we have some gap. Okay, like this. Now let's select this one, the simple text. Let's minimize this, maximize the simple text. Let's change the what do we have to change? I think we don't have to change anything, everything is looking proper. Just increase the size to 16 pixels. Okay, rest everything is fine. Click on OK. After this we have this button, so we don't have to create this button. Just click on add new module, add from library, and select button. And let's make it left align, select the alignment. Okay, click on Control S. Now as you can see, once you create a basic structure for the website, once you have used and created different modules, like we have created button, we have created the title, and we have created the header, and we have saved them to different libraries, and after that you don't have to create those things again and again. We can just use them anywhere we want on our website. Okay, so that is very useful and it saves a lot of time. Now let's see what we have next. Again, we have two different sections. Okay, so again, click on this add new row, two columns. In the first column, we have some simple text. So we can just copy this text from here. Search for text, select this, paste in this text. Okay, go to design, text. Let's increase this size to 16 pixels. Okay, everything is fine. Click on OK. After that, we have this progress bars. So again, hover here and click on this plus button or module and search for bar, which is bar counters. Select this. Now click on add to add the first bar, And here the title is search engine optimization. So I'll just copy this title from here. And the percentage is 95. So just type in 95% over here. Okay. Now you can select background from here. You can select any background. Okay. Now if you change the background here, as you can see, this changes. Now I don't want to change any background. So what I'll do, I'll just delete this color. Now go to design, go to bar counter. Now bar background color, select this and now it will change this main color. Okay, you can select any color you want. You can change the color from here. I think this is looking better. After that we have text and title text. First change the title text. So select title text. Let's increase the text of the title. Let's make it maybe 20 pixels is looking fine. Let's increase the line height so that we have some gap. 1.8 I think is fine. And what we have, okay, so we have, let's make it bolder, okay, bold or maybe semi bold. Okay, this is looking better. After that let's go to percentage text and let's increase this to maybe 18 or maybe 16. Let's make it 16. Then go to border and let's add some rounded corners. So let's make it 20. And as you can see, now this is how it is looking. Okay, exactly like this one. Okay, so after that, just click on OK. Now we have to copy these things two times. Now as you can see, we have it. Now suppose you want to change the second one, you can click on OK, text. And this time, let's type in email marketing. Let's change the percentage to maybe 85. Click on OK. Now select the third one. Let's change the text to affiliate sales. And let's make the percentage to 70. Okay. So it is that easy. Click on OK and everything is done. And in this column also we have a simple image. So what I'll do is I'll copy this image. I'll drag it over here. And let's just change the image. Okay. All the style remains same. We just have to change the image. Let's select this one. Upload an image, OK. Press Ctrl S to save the changes. Okay, so with this section is also complete. Now let's see what we have next. After that, we have this thing, a very beautiful section again. Let's see how to do this. Add a new section, click on this plus button, blue plus button, regular. And let's see, first we have two different columns. So select two columns. And after that, first thing is a simple title, which says availability, select that and search for text area over here, text. Type in any title you want and make sure you to make that heading 1, heading 2, whatever you like. Okay, so I'm making it heading 2. Go to design, select heading text and go to H2 because we selected heading 2. And let's make it bolder, so select bold. Let's change the color to blue, dark blue. Okay, it is looking better. And let's also increase the size to maybe 35 pixels. Click on OK. Okay, after that we have this thing over here. This is also a blurb. So again, what I'll do is I'll hover over here, click on this plus button, plus module, and search for blurb. Select this thing. Now here the title is this, long-term availability. Now again, I'm going faster, as I said you earlier, because we have seen how to use these blurbs and everything in the home page. Now I don't want to waste your time and mine to show the same thing again and again. That's why I'm going a little bit faster. Now we have to select an icon. So go to image and icon, use icon. And for this, we have the icon of clock. So let's search for clock icon. Here it is, select this icon. Okay, you'll see it something like this. Okay, now go to design, image and icon. Icon color, we want to make it white. Okay, now and make this icon circle and you can select this circle color. Okay, you can select the circle color, anything you want, blue, red, whatever you like. Fine, after selecting this color, change the placement from top to left. Okay. And you can increase the font size, this icon size accordingly. Okay. Yeah, I'm making it 30 pixels. You can make it 25, anything. So let's make it 25 pixels. Now select title text to change this text. Select heading 2 or heading 4 if you want to make it smaller. Let's make it, size is fine, I guess. Let's make it center align. So to do that, let's add some line height of maybe 1.8 or 2 em. Let's add the line height of 2 em. Now go to spacing, add bottom margin to 0. We have seen all these things. Okay, that's why I'm going a little bit faster. Click on OK. Now copy these things 2-3 times, whatever you like. And similarly, you can change this text to whatever you like, and you can also change the icon. Okay, so for this, let's change the third one. The icon is this map and the address is this San Francisco Bay Area. So let's change the title. Let's go down, change the icon to this map icon. Let's search that. Here it is. Okay, so we have this map icon. Click on OK. It is that easy. Now after that, we have this thing, the title which says review. So we can just copy this title, bring it over here, and just change this thing to reviews. And after that, we have this simple text. So just copy it. Click on this plus button, plus module, search for text, and let's paste it over here. Very simple text. Go to design, text. Let's increase the size to 16 pixels. Let's add 1.8 line height. Okay, it is looking nice. Click on OK. Now after that, we have this section, which is the person section. Okay, so click on add new row, and let's make it 3 columns because we have 3 different persons over here. Now come here and search for person. We have this module over here. Okay, so the first one is name. Let's type in person1, position, CEO, Facebook profile. Just put this hashtag for Facebook, Twitter, Google Plus, LinkedIn, everything. And for description, let's copy it from here. Copy it and paste this description over here. Image, you can upload an image. Click on upload and upload this image. Click on upload an image. Fine. After that, what we have, we don't have anything. Go to design. First is text. Select text. Okay, design. Select the image. We have some nice shadow in the image. Okay. And we also have this rounded color, so let's make it 30 rounded corners. Now let's change the title text. Okay, let's increase this. So let's make it heading 2. Let's make it center align. Okay, bold. After that, we have body text. Okay, this is the text. We'll make it center align. Increase the size to 16 pixels. Okay, let's also increase the line height to 1.8. Okay, it is looking better. Okay, we have title text, and then we have this text. Okay, once doing everything, click on OK, and let's copy this module, paste it over here, copy it again, and drag it over here. Now instead of this person 1, you can put person 2, person 3. Instead of CEO, you can put in manager, whatever you like. And you can also easily change the image. Okay, it's really, really easy. Now let's add this divider over here at the top. So select this. Okay, first let's add a background color. Select this one, click on OK. Now this time we have a different kind of background color. So what I'll do, I'll select the first color. And we have something like this. Okay, we have something like this. Now select the second color and let's select white. Okay, so we have the color and dark. When it goes down, it becomes lighter, and at the end it becomes white. Okay, so that is what we mean. Now go to design, divider, top, select the design. Let's select this one and let's make the color as white. Okay, let's increase the size or height. Fine, click on OK. Let's add some gap at top. Fine. Okay, so this is looking better. And at the end, we have to add our footer. So I think we didn't add or we didn't save the footer section. Okay, in the library, I think. Let's search. Add from library. Ah, yeah, we only have the header. We forgot to add the footer in the library. Don't worry, we can do it easily. So we have our homepage over here. Let's open this homepage in a new tab. Okay, click on enable visual builder. Okay, scroll down. Okay, so this is our footer section. Select this thing, click on save section. Let's name it footer. Click on save to library and cut this thing. Now to use this thing, first we'll have to refresh this page. So let's refresh. Now go at the bottom, click on plus button, add from library, and we have this footer section over here. Okay, we just have to do one thing. Click on this section, go to design, divider, and divider color, let's make it white so that we have this white color matching over here. Click on OK. Okay, so with this, we also have our this thing ready. We also have our about us page ready. Now let's see what we have next. After that, we have our services page. Let's see how it looks. Okay, so this is how it is looking. Now we have this thing same, this is the same footer section, and this is what we have created in the home page. If you see, let me show. Let's open this home page. So in this, we only have to create this section. Okay, this section, why choose us section. Okay, we have created this section, as I said you. So let's again save this section as services section so that we can use it while creating services page. So let me save this section to the library and let's name it services. Click on save to library so that we can use it over here. And we already have this header. We just have to create this section over here, okay, which is very easy. So come back over here. We are completed with the about us page. Now hover this new and click on page to add a new page, services page. Let's add a title of services. Click on use the visual builder, use default visual builder. Okay, so first we'll have to add this header section, which we have already saved in the library. So click on plus button, add from library, header, and let's delete this section, which is already over here. Let's delete it and let's change this thing to what we do. And this thing to our services. I'm sorry. Our services, fine. Okay, so after that we have to create this section. So click on add new section, regular, two columns. The first is simple text over here. Okay, so I'll select this thing and just search for text. Okay, first select why choose us. Okay, paste it over here and make sure it is heading. Then after that we have these two simple text, copy it, paste it over here. Now this text is blue color, so what I'll do is I'll select this color, and you can also change the color of the text from here. Okay, you can, okay, where is the option? Here it is, text color, and you can make it blue if you want. Okay, you can change it to any color. Let's select this blue. Okay, let me see. Fine, so you can see this text has become blue. Now click on this design option, heading text. Okay, first let's see heading 2 it was. Let's increase the heading size to 35. Okay, let's make it bolder. Change the color to blue, dark blue. And the rest everything is fine. You can also add some more line height if you want. Okay, 1.4 is better. And after that, select the simple text, first one. Let's increase this size to 16, which is looking fine. Click on OK. After that, we have this section over here. Okay, so I think we have to change the column setting. It is not one by one. Now it is, I guess, this one. Okay, this is the one. It is okay. Select this one. We have one column and two different columns over here. Now click on Add New Module and search for blurb. Select this, and here we have an image and some text. So put in the text over here, 5-star service, and image and icon. Search for image, upload the image, upload files. And let me search this image. It is services page. So here it is, 4 images. Upload it. Select this star one, upload an image. Okay, so we have the image, we have the title, and we have to add a background color this time. Okay, so select a background color, select white. Now you won't see any changes because already the background color is white, but what we'll do is we'll change this background color to gray and this will become white. So this is how it will look. Okay, now go to design, image and icon is fine. Go to title, make it center align, make it center align. Let's increase the size to maybe 20 pixels is fine, and let's change the color where it is to dark blue. Okay, click on OK. First, let's change the color of this background so that we can see this white background for this blurb. So select this color, select background, select it, and you can select any background color. Now if you see, we can see this we can see the white background. So I want to select a background color and I want to put a code of F2, F5, F7. Okay, it will make this thing like this. Now we want to add the same code for this background, for the first section. So select the first section, go to design, divider, divider bottom, and divider color instead of white, select the same so that these two thing matches. Okay, click on OK. Now again, we can click on this edit blurb buttons. Now we can see the changes. Go to design. Let's add some space padding from all the sides. Let's add maybe 20 pixels from all the sides, 20 pixels padding from all the sides. And now let's add some border corners, rounded corners. Let's make it 30. Okay, so this is how it is looking. Okay, exactly like this one. Now what we can do is, I think we can decrease the padding from the bottom. Go to spacing and let's delete this. Let's see what happens. Yeah, we don't have to do padding. Bottom will be 0, rest all the padding will be 20 pixels. Click on OK. Save the changes. Now let's again copy it and drag it over here. Copy it and drag it over here and again copy it. So we have 4 things over here, just like this one. We have 1, 2, 3, 4. We just have to change the title from here, no wait list. Here also we want no wait list, available 24/7, available 24/7, scheduled ahead. Okay, now let's change the images over here. For this, we have this image. So go at the bottom, image and icon, upload, select this, click on upload an image. Okay, now for this one, available 24/7, we have this clock image. Go at the bottom, upload the image, select this, click on upload an image. Okay, and for the last one, we have the calendar image, I guess. Image and icon, upload, and calendar, upload an image. Okay. Okay, so we have created this section. What we have next, at the bottom, if you see, we have this simple divider. It is a very simple divider. So let's add that. Select this section setting, design, divider bottom, and select this simple one, which is this one. Okay, click on OK. After that, we have this section which we have already created, the services section. So we can just click on add new. Okay, after that, add from library and services. Okay, we have the services section, and after that we have the footer. So click on add new, add from library, footer. Okay, we just have to change this color. So change, select it, design, divider, top, change this color to white. Okay, click on OK. So with this, we have also completed the services page. Let's see what we have next. After that, we have the blog page. So let's see how the blog looks like, how the blog page looks like. So this is how the blog page looks like. Okay. So first, instead of creating a new page, first we'll have to create some blogs so that we can, you know, use those blogs. Here we have around 6 different blogs. Okay. So what we can do is we can hover this new, and instead of adding a new page, we'll click on add a new post. Okay. Now let's copy this title from here, or let's add a new, let's open this blog first. Okay. So this is the title. Let's copy it, paste it. And this is the content. Copy it from here, paste it. And we also have a featured image. This is the featured image, which is shown over here. If you go back, which is shown over here. So let's select the featured image. Click on upload, and you'll find all these images in the blog folder. All these images, click on upload, select everything and click on upload. You can select any image you want. Let's select this image, click on set featured image. And you can give it a category. You can add a new category from here. For example, let's add a category blog, add new category. Let's publish this post. Okay, so similarly, you can create unlimited number of blogs, but we won't do that because one blog is enough for us. We don't want to do the same changes again and again. We will use that one blog to design it like this. So now click on this button again, hover this new, and now let's add a new page called blog page. Let's give it a title of blog. Use the DB builder, use visual builder. Now again, the first section is the same section. So what you can do is we can click on add new, add from library, header. We can delete this section, and it says articles are blog. So we can just type in articles, and instead of about us, we can type in our blog. Okay. Fine. Then after that, we have the blogs over here. So click on add new section, regular and single column, and search for blog. Now number of posts to show, we will select, as you can see over here, we are showing 6 posts. So I'll select six over here. And what are the different elements do you want to show? For example, if you see over here, we are showing the featured image, we are showing the title, the date, and the excerpt. Okay, so we are showing the featured image. We are not showing the author, so I'll make it no. We are showing the date. We are not showing the category, so I'll make it no. Pagination, which is fine. Okay, so this is the only thing that we are showing at present. And if you see over here, okay, this is looking better. Now again, come back over here, go to design, layout, instead of full width, select grid. Okay, so this is the grid layout. Now we can design it easily. We can also add an overlay. If you see at present, if any hover this, nothing happens, but we can add an overlay. And you know, when you hover this, you can see this new icon. You can change the icon. You can change the icon color. You can change the hover overlay color. Okay, but I don't want to add any overlay. Now what we can do is, now we can select the title text. Now as you can see over here, the title text is blue, then the date or the meta text is red, and rest everything is normal. So let's select the title text. Let's decrease the size to 15 pixels. Let's give it a color of blue. Fine. Now after that, we have the meta text. Here it is, meta text. Let's increase the size to 12. Let's add a color of red. Fine. Okay, rest everything is fine. Click on OK. Now you'll see box shadow. Now let's add a shadow to this box, and let's also give it rounded corners. So go to border, and let's add 30 pixels rounded corners, and this is looking amazing. Click on OK. Okay, so this is how your post is looking right now, and it is looking exactly like this. So make sure you save all the settings, and with this we have completed the blog page as well. And you can add this thing at the bottom. Okay, just add it, add from library, footer, and let's change the color to white, divider color, fine, click on OK, save all the changes. With this we have completed the blog page. Now let's see the booking page. Click on booking. Okay, so this is how our booking page is looking. Very beautiful page. So again, come back over here, hover new, click on page, type in booking as the title, fine, DB builder, visual builder. Okay, here also we have the title, the first section is the same. Okay, so again we'll click on add new. Okay, add from library, header, let's delete this. Now here there are some changes. The background color is quite different, so let's see how to do that. Go to background, select the color one. Now let's select light blue color, something like this, and for the second one, more lighter color. Okay, so let's make it more lighter. Okay, it is looking something like this. Click on OK, and here it says ready to book and booking. So instead of about us, let's type in booking, and instead of our story, ready to book. Fine, click on save changes. Let's add some gap at the bottom. Then after that we have these three things. Now these are also blurbs, so which is very easy to create. So what we can do is we can add this new row, three columns, search for blurb, select this one. Now the title here is step one, and after that we have fill out the form below. So the title here is step one, and the text is fill out the form below. So let's type this. Then after that we have an icon, this note icon, so use an icon, and let's search for this. I think here it is, I think this is the one, select this. Okay, now go to design. Okay, first before that we also have to add a background color, so let's make a background color, let's make it white. Okay, this is how it is looking. Go to design, first is image. Okay, we have the image at the top, which is fine, but we have to change the icon color. The icon color is white and the background color is blue. So select the icon color, make it white. Okay, make the circle icon and change the circle color. Change it to any color you want. Okay, after that what we have, let's see, let's minimize this icon setting. Then we have title text. Okay, here the title text is bold and blue. And center align, obviously, make it center align. Let's make it bold. Let's change the color to blue. Okay, after that we have simple text. This is the one, body text. Everything is fine, just make it center align. Then after that we have spacing. Okay, let's add some space, some padding from all the sides. Let me add 35 pixels. Okay, so we have 35 pixels from all the sides. After that, let's add some rounded corners. Let's add 30 pixels rounded corners, and let's also add a box shadow like this one. Okay, so this is looking amazing. I think we have to change, let's change the color of this title. Okay, it is looking fine. Fine, it is fine. Let's decrease this gap. Okay, from here. Okay, this is looking better. Click on save. Let's copy this module. Let's bring it over here. Copy it again. Bring it over here. And similarly, you can change all the settings, all the icon, the text, and the subtext. After that, let's start working on this thing. But before that, first we'll have to change the background color for the section that is coming next. So add a new section. Click on this blue button, regular, single. and let's search for form, contact form. Select this, but just click on OK. First, let's change the background color for this section. So select this section, background, select color and put in the code F2, F5, F7. Now here you'll see some difference because this is the background color white and this is this different color. So select this first section, go to design, divider, bottom, color and put in the same color F2, F5, F7. Now we can see the same color over here. Okay. Now select this section, the contact form section. Click on this gear icon. First, let's add this booking form as the title. So go to text, add a title, booking form. And we don't want the captcha. I hope the captcha is off. Let's not display the captcha. Okay. Then go to background and make it white. Select white background, not black, white. And okay, now go to design. First is title. You can see it is blue and bold. So select bold from here. And the color should be blue, which is over here. Fine. After that, we have the fields, form fields. So select form field. And first is to increase the line height. Okay, if you increase the line height, the size of this thing will also increase. Then after that, what we have, let's see what we have. We have a different color in the background. Let's see what we have. So if you want to find that color, it's really easy. You can just right click over here, click on inspect. Now you'll see some colors over here. Let's search. Okay, here it is. I think this is the color, background color. It says F5, FA, F6, FC. Okay, let's see. Form fill text color. And we should have form fill background color. Let's see what we had. F5, FA, FC. Okay, now this is looking better. Okay, form fill text color is same. But we have to add some border color to this field. As you can see, some gray border color. So let's see where we have that border, and let's add some border color. Let's add a border width of 1 pixels, and we don't want not 3, just 1 pixels, and we don't want black. We want to gray border color. So let's get something like this. Okay. This is looking better, and let's add some border radius, maybe of 20 pixels. Or maybe more. Okay, 20 pixels is looking fine. After that, go to spacing and add some padding of 35 from all the sides. Okay, 35. Okay, so at present this is how it is looking. Okay, not 350, 35. Fine. Now after that we have to add this corners, rounded corners. So we can just click on OK. Now select this thing, this option, this row option, go to design, select border, and let's make it 50. Okay, let's make it 100 maybe. Let's make it 100. Now this is not looking nice because we have this gap. Delete this gap from both top and bottom. Now as you can see, this is looking nice. Now we don't want 100, 100 is a lot. Let's make it 50 again. Go to design, border, and let's make it 50 pixels. Okay, it is looking better. Click on OK. Okay. Now we also need to add the border shadow so that it looks nice. Box shadow. So go to design, shadow, select any shadow you like. I am selecting the first one like always. Click on OK. Now only one thing is left over here to do the changes to this button. So again, select this gear icon, go to design, button, and here if you see, very simple button. There is no hover effect over here. Button remains same in normal state, and in hover state the color of the background is white and the text color is the color of the background is blue and the text color is white. So custom settings, let's decrease the size to 18. Button text color is white. Okay. No border width. And where is the background color option? I think I missed it. Let's see background color option. Okay, here it is, background color. Let's search some blue color over here, some simple light blue color. Okay, like this. Fine. Let's add some radius to this. Let's make it circular, like this. Fine. Okay, so this is looking amazing. Click on save. What do we have next? We have the last section over here, which is the fact section. Let's add some gap at the bottom first, like this. Add a new column, regular, single column, text, and just type in FAQ, F-A-Q. Go to design, text. Okay, it's all. Let's increase the size to 40 pixels. Make it ultra bold. Let's make the color blue and let's make it center align. Fine. Then after that we have three different columns. First click on OK. Add new row, three columns, text. First we have a simple heading text, and then first copy this text, then after that copy this text, simple one. Go to visual, select the first text, make it heading 2. Not everything, just the first text. Just select this much, make it heading 2. Then select this text, the bottom text. Make it paragraph. Fine. Now go to design, select the heading text. Okay, the color is blue and bold. So select bold from here. Okay, heading 2 it was. Select bold. Center align. Size is quite smaller, so let's make it 20. Color will be blue. Fine. Now select the normal text, the first one. Size is 16 and center align. Click on OK. Now copy this, drag it over here, copy it, drag it over here, and you can change the question and answer for this thing. Okay, the title and the subtitle from here. Now this section is also complete. Make sure you save it. Okay, so this beautiful section is also done. Now let's see what we have next. Now the last section is remaining, which is the get in touch section. Let's see how it looks. Okay, a very simple, very simple section, really easy to create. Let's see how to do that. Hover new and click on page. Now we can give it any title you want. So let's give it get in touch, DB builder, visual builder. Let's add the header section, add from library, header. Let's delete this. Here it says get in touch contact. So instead of our story, let's type in get in touch, and instead of about us, let's type in contact us. Okay, so after that we have this form, the contact form. Let's add this. Hover this, click on this plus module button and search for contact form. Here it is. Fine. So what all we have? We have the name, email address, phone number and message, and it is all full width. So we can select this name, go to design, layout, make it full width. Okay, again, go back, select the email address, design, layout, and make it full width. Okay, now go to content again, and we don't want make it yes. Go at the bottom, elements, and remove this captcha. Okay, we don't have any title or anything. We don't have any styling option as well. We just have to make the button colors white. So go to design, scroll down, and after that we have button, make custom style, button text color, make it white. Okay, rest everything is fine. Just have to do this much. Now let's add some gap at the top of this section. So okay, this much or maybe a little bit more. Now what we can do is we can add some padding from both the sides so that the form becomes a bit smaller. So select this, go to design, spacing, and let's add some padding right and left, maybe 50 pixels. Okay, or maybe more. Let's add 100 pixels padding from both the sides. Okay, so this is looking much better. You can increase the padding if you want. If you want to make it smaller, you can increase it. At present, this is how it is looking. Now after that, we have this very simple section. So again, click on this add new section, regular, three different columns, and this is simple text. Okay, so search for text. We have this text, it says address. Just type it over here, go to design, text. Okay, then let's increase the size to maybe 35. Fine. Let's make it center align, make it bold, change the color to blue. Okay, this much. Okay. After that, click on OK. After that, let's click on add new module, add from a library, small divider. Okay, we have the divider over here. After that, what we have some more text. So just copy this text from here. Again, click on this plus button, search for text, and let's add this text over here. Go to design, text, and just make it center aligned. Rest everything is fine. Okay, just make it center align, click on OK. Now what you can do, you can select this section, this row setting, background, background 1, background 2. So for background 1, you can add this colors, color code F2, F5, F7. Okay, or maybe a darker one. I think let's add, make it more darker. Okay, like this, and copy this code. Okay, whatever you're using, and do it for the same for the background column 2 as well, and for column 3 as well. Okay, now go to design, spacing. Let's add some padding for all the columns. So column 1 padding, let's add 35 pixels from all the sides. Similarly for column 2 padding, 35 pixels from all the sides. Column 3, 35 from all the sides, click on OK, and you can copy these things from here. Okay, drag it over here and just change the text. Okay, just copy and paste, and you can just change the text. Fine, so this is also done. You just have to change the text, address to phone, and all these things. Okay, so with this we have completed all the pages. Now let's save everything and let's go to our home page. So let's click over here. Now if you see over here, we have created a home page, but this is not showing up. Okay, so let's do that setting from here. From here, let's go to your dashboard. So when you go to your dashboard, at the left hand side you will see settings, hover settings, and click on reading. Now the first option is home page display. By default, latest post is selected. Select a static page, select the home page, and select the home page which we have created, post page, and the blog page which we have created. Select these two pages, click on save changes. Now when we refresh this page, everything should be changed. Now as you can see, when we refresh this page, this has become our blog page. Now let's see how to create this menu, because we have different sections. When we click on this contact us, we are redirected to contact us. When we click on get in touch, we are redirected to this section. Let's see how to do that. So again, hover here, hover this appearances, and click on menus. Okay, let's create a new menu. You can name it anything. I'm naming it new menu. Click on create menu. Now this is our home page. Click on this enable visual builder. Now first we want all the pages, so click on view all and select the home page, about us page, blog, booking, get in touch, okay, and services page. Select everything, click on add to menu. Now make sure primary menu is selected from here. Now we want the home page, then the blog page. You can, you know, just we want the get in touch at the end. Fine. Now under blog page over here, under home page, we have different sections. Like when you click on about us, you're redirected to this section. So let's see how to do that. So before that, we'll have to give a class ID to all this section. Okay, so for example, for this section, let's give it a class ID of services. So what you can do is we can edit this row, go to advanced, CSS ID and classes, and let's give it a ID of services. Just type in services, click on OK. Okay, now click on over here, go to custom links, copy your website URL from here, paste it over here. After your website URL, after your website name slash, put a hashtag and put in services, the ID which you have put. Okay, we have put the ID services. Now you just have to put that and type in anything you want, like services. Click on add to menu. Now drag the services under home page. Okay, now let's see again, it is your website name slash this hashtag and the ID. Okay, for example, the ID over here in the advanced section, the ID, CSS ID, services. So we have the services over here. Now similarly, you can give ID to all this section. Let's give it ID to this section. Let's give it an ID of contact. Go to advanced, CSS ID, give it contact, click on OK. Now again, repeat the same thing. Put in your website name over here, give it an ID of contact, add to menu, drag it over here. And similarly, you can give a ID to all these sections. Okay, I think, okay, name was incorrect. Now click on save menu. Now come back to your website and refresh this page. Okay, wait, first save all these settings. After that, refresh this page. Okay, so we have our menu over here. We have everything. Now let's make this menu transparent. Okay, so what we can do, we can come over here and in fact, we can just delete this thing. Now, when you hover this, you'll see this theme customizer. Click on this. Fine. Now here you'll see this header and navigation. Select that. Header format. You can change the header format if you want. Then we have to select this one, primary menu bar. After that, we have the text color, active link color, then we have the background color. Select the background color and select this second thing and make it to the bottom. Now, as you can see, it has become transparent. Fine. So this is how it works. Now if you make it transparent, you also have to make some different changes. Like if you see the link color is now disappearing and here the link color is yellow and this normal color is white. So let's do that. Active link color, let's make it yellow. Okay, now the active link color becomes yellow and the text color, let's make it white. So the text color becomes white. We have all the white colors over here. Fine. And drop down menu line color, you have this blue line color. Drop down menu text color, you have the text color as black. You can change this to white as well. Okay, now this also becomes white. It's all up to you. Once you're done, just click on publish. Okay, now as you can see, this is working, but there is one problem. When you hover, when you scroll down, this menu disappears. That is because the background is transparent. Now that is, we have to change that. So what you can do, you can just come back and select this setting, fixed navigation setting, and select this option, which is primary menu background color, and select black or some different, this kind of color like this. Okay, black. Okay, so this is looking better now. So here it is transparent, but when you scroll down, it becomes something like this. Once you are satisfied with this, click on publish. Now at the bottom, we have this setting, okay, designed by elegant theme and all this thing. Now we have to change that, the footer settings. So come back, we have the footer section over here, select footer. After that, we have the footer elements, select footer elements. This is the social icon. If you don't want to show the social icon, you can just untick this, it will disappear. Okay, then after that, we have the bottom bar. Okay, in the bottom bar, you can type anything like it, edit footer credits. You can type in like designed. You can see it is typing over there, designed by Nayar Sheikh. Now you can see the text over here, designed by Nayar Sheikh. Click on publish. Fine, now you can cancel this thing. Okay, so I think this is complete and this is looking really, really amazing. Okay guys, so this is how you create a website using DB theme. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. I hope you guys liked it. If you guys like this video, make sure to click on that subscribe button and also click on that bell icon so that you don't miss any future videos. If you guys have any doubt, any questions, any queries, any request for me, you can leave them in the comment section below. Thanks a lot for watching guys. See you soon.